Welcome back. Coming up, it's the NHL playoffs. The Blues host the Red Wings. And don't forget, after the game, to catch Fox Sports News for a complete wrap-up, plus the rest of the day's scores and highlights. Right now, here's Ken Wilson and Joe Micheletti with the call.
The 1997 NHL Stanley Cup playoffs continue. At the Kiel Center tonight, a big crowd on hand, near capacity. And the Blues and the Red Wings continue their best of seven Western Conference quarterfinal series. This is game four, and the Red Wings have won two of the first three. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Kiel. Ken Wilson with Joe Micheletti. Rob Ramage is also with us tonight. The Blues obviously need a victory, but bad news all of a sudden with Igor Kravchuk already out. Now tonight, Joe, Pierre Turgeon will not play.
Pierre Turgeon has been suffering from recurring headaches. Yesterday, he had a CAT scan. This morning, he had an MRI, and it's a medical decision by the Blues to keep him out of this game. And what that means now is that Robert Petrovicki, who has not played in this series, suddenly gets in the game, and Harry York, who sat out game three, also gets inserted back in.
The Blues won the first game in Detroit. They lost game two in Detroit, lost the third game here on Sunday afternoon. They have not been disciplined enough. Very simply, Rob Ramage, taking too many penalties.
Well, they sure do. If you spend half the game in the sin bin, you can't win. And it really takes its toll on defensemen, especially when the Blues are only really going with 3D. Al MacInnis, Chris Pronger, and Mark Bergevin. But it's real simple. Joel Quenneville said it. They have to initiate and not retaliate. And then I like their chances. Let's go back upstairs.
All right. Thanks very much, Rob. The Blues are on the ice. The Red Wings are taking the ice. The Blues, the Wings. It's Stanley Cup playoff hockey coming up next. Fox Sports Midwest presents Blues Hockey. Brought to you by Bud Ice, official beer sponsor of the NHL. Drink Bud Ice, but beware the Penguins. By Discover Card, proud sponsor of the Smithsonian's 150th anniversary. By Ameritech, your link to better communications. By your neighborhood Chrysler Plymouth dealers. By Casino Queen, we know what floats your boat. And by Southwest Airlines, with fares so low, you have the freedom to go places.
Blue stripes and white stars through the perilous fight. For the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming. And the runner's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, echo through the night. And our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? All of land of the free and love of the brave.
Joe Concilio with tonight's national anthem. The starting goaltenders for tonight's game. Boy, these two have been something. In goal for Detroit will be the veteran Mike Vernon. In goal, he has allowed just 5 goals. Look at that, goals against average 1.68. And in goal for the Blues is, of course, Grant Fuhr. Also has allowed 5 goals in the series, a 1.69 goals against average. Our officials for tonight's game, our referee, is Mark Fossett. The linesman, Gerard Gauthier, and Jean Morin. Well, Joe Quenneville said to his team's got to come out and play desperate hockey in this game. This is obviously a game that they need to win. You hate to go down 3-1 to Detroit and have to go back there for a game Friday and have to win the last two games in Detroit.
The Blues have not beaten the Detroit Red Wings here at Kiel Center this season. They have lost to them twice here, and the Wings and Blues have played to a tie.
Ken, interesting starting lineup. Conroy at center, Hull on one side, Twist on the other.
With McInnes, who shoots the puck in, and Bergevin on defense. Back for Detroit. This is Konstantinov. He's on with Lidstrom. Here's Yzerman to Fedorov. Lapointe on the right wing. The pass to him tipped away. And Fedorov has to circle. We're in the first minute, and there's no score here in game four. Nicholas Lidstrom. Over to Vladimir Konstantinov, to Sergei Fedorov, who shoots the puck in. And back to play. It is McInnes up the boards. Twist. As the teams change to York, he'll flip it in. York, as Joe mentioned, in. So is Robert Petrovicki, with McTavish and Turgeon out. It's Draper. Nice pass, but it's offside. Draper and McCarty with that play. They're offside at the St. Louis blue line.
Well, Chris Pronger made that play again, coming over all the way from the left defense as he is paired with Chris McAlpine. And what a game Pronger is coming off of. Even though the Blues lost game three, Pronger in game number three, he had 10 hits, 7 shots. He played 35 minutes and 44 seconds. And Detroit did not have one scoring chance when Pronger was on the ice in game number three.
You mentioned he's on with Chris McAlpine. McAlpine was going to see spot duty in game number three. He played so well, he gained the confidence of Joel Quenneville and saw quite a bit of ice time.
Well, the thing he can really do, and we haven't seen much of it because he hasn't played much, he's got a terrific shot.
Now the Wings have a player caught offside. Pusher, he was dumped by Petrovicki, and that creates an offside call. Let's give you all the scratches for tonight's game number four. Igor Kravchuk, Pierre Turgeon are out. The ribs for Kravchuk, the headaches for Turgeon. McTavish, Momesso, and Yanni are healthy scratches. For Detroit, goaltender Kevin Hodgson, along with Matthew Dandineau, Tomas Holmstrom, Doug Brown, Mike Knubel, and Tim Taylor. They were all out of game number three. We're in the first minute of game number four. Petrovicki with Peluso and Campbell. And on defense now, Pronger with Bergevin. They got a bit of a delay, so Bergevin was able to come out with Pronger, and the puck deflects into the crowd. If the game has enough stoppages and enough whistles, then that gives Joel Quenneville a chance to use really three defensemen at times, also to really shorten his bench, which he hates to do, but can if things go his way.
Yeah, and Scotty Bowman said yesterday, he said, well, our team has to play better than we did in game three. He expects the penalty situation, the power play opportunities for both teams to go down in this game. Both teams have been shorthanded more than any other teams in the playoffs this season.
Jamie Pusher shoots the puck in. He is on with Bob Rouse. The Blues control McInnes. Draper, Koser, and Maltby for Detroit. Petrovicki to Peluso, working in. Now to Campbell, and the shot off Rouse high and wide. Peluso centering the puck to the point. Al McInnes, the slap shot. Vernon the save. Now Campbell and McInnes converge. McInnes plays the puck to Petrovicki behind the net. Also Peluso there, but the Wings control. Kirk Maltby. Head manning to Chris Draper. He'll dump the puck in, and the two teams begin to change. We're in the very early going of game number four. Pronger can't clear, and this is Bergevin for the Blues. Up front, it is York with Pellerin, and the puck shot in. Campbell being replaced now. And the Blues try to keep it in. Can't. Back is McAlpine. Sandstrom with a puck. And he's forced to the corner. Good play by Chris McAlpine. Now Joe Murphy on that line with Pellerin and York. Pellerin can't get the puck out. Oh, yes, it did just come out over the blue line. Shot back in. Offside. And play stopped with 2:10 gone. In a scoreless first period, Detroit has not had a shot on goal. The Blues have had just the one.
Yeah, and it was a pretty good opportunity. The Blues, of course, want to play 5-on-5 in this game. There's the one shot that was deflected. That was by Campbell. And Al McInnes will end up with a chance from the other point. And Mike Vernon had to make a good save on McInnes.
You get McInnes shooting the puck, usually good things are going to happen sooner or later. And the faceoff with Demitra against Yzerman. Hull and Courtnall with Pavol Demitra. Pearson is on with Pronger. Now Aaron Ward fires the puck in for Detroit. And he's quickly replaced. The puck cleared out. Lidstrom and Konstantinov on defense. Yzerman, the Wings captain, slides the puck right to Fuhr. He'll cover it. as Kozloff and Sandstrom are there, and we'll have a faceoff near Grant Fuhr. A lot of whistles here in the first 2:26.
Yeah, and we've seen both coaches do a lot of line changes here in the early going, and Lidstrom is a player that is so good defensively. He's a great skater. He handles the puck well. And Scotty Bowman will try and keep Lidstrom on the ice as much as possible against Brett Hull, even though he had the giveaway in game number three that led to Brett Hull's goal. But this is a player that can do a lot of things for Detroit.
It'll be York facing off with Larionov. Larionov is between Shanahan and LaPointe. Murphy at the right point, Ward at the left point. They battle for the puck. York knocks the puck away. Then it's centered to Larionov. And the feed out of the reach of LaPointe, who's slowed up by Murphy. And they say interfered with a bit. Pronger fires the puck around, not out. Joel Murphy, or I should say Larry Murphy, the shot blocked. York clears it out. Joel Murphy on for the Blues. And of course, Larry Murphy for Detroit. Joel Murphy works in, and it's offside. The Blues offside at the Detroit blue line. And the first few minutes here have not been as physical as we have typically seen in the first three games. But on the other hand, it's been very tough to get anything going with so many whistles.
Well, and the reason we're seeing all the whistles is both teams are basically trying to do the same thing. They're trying to stand up at the blue lines and not allow the other team to come into the zone. So all the whistles we have had, or at least the majority of them, have been because of teams going offside.
Nobody getting tired early except the linesman. Now the faceoff, Larionov and York. The puck shot in. Larry Murphy back. York is centering, Pellerin and Joe Murphy, Pronger and Bergevin on defense. Larry Murphy gives the puck on the far wing to LaPointe. His pass will go down the ice, rather to Aaron Ward, and his pass too far. Bergevin touches it, icing against Detroit. Early first period, and there is no score. Here are Fox Sports Midwest and NHL Cup Crazy banner winners. The first from Beth Applebaum, and this is Kathy Boyles. They each win four tickets to tonight's game for designing a Blues banner. Congratulations. Great contest. A lot of people took part. A lot of excitement and a lot of fun. No score here. Faceoff won by the Blues. Back to McInnes. Now to Craig Conroy behind the net. Machaux on also with Leach. This is Leach in the corner. The pass deflects by Pronger. McInnes the big shot, and it goes well wide. Pronger lets it go, and a deflection right on, and Vernon the save. Lidstrom just shot the puck over the glass, and Mark Fawcett, the referee, going, no, 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 that's not delay a game. Some of the fans thought it should have been.
Well, the Blues with a couple of chances. Now, Joe Quenneville has talked to his team about trying to hit the net a little bit more. There's the deflection, and Mike Vernon had to make a good save. And there you saw Lidstrom. He just threw the puck over the glass. Prior to that, Al McInnes had a good chance from the other side as well. It just missed. Vernon didn't see it. Here's McInnes keeping it in. Now he'll take the shot. It just goes wide on the far side. You can see Vernon down on the ice. The Blues had plenty of players. Steve Leach was parked directly in front of Vernon, which you have to do. And that shot by McInnes just missed the far post.
Conroy, Matteau, and Leach up front. McInnes and Pronger on the points for this faceoff. And the wings, Lidstrom with a puck. He feeds up the middle. Nice pass. Fedorov now to McCarty. Eiserman trails. Back to Fedorov. Stopped at the blue line. That's another thing the Blues have to do consistently. Stand up at their own line. McInnes and Vernon the save. Konstantinov clears the puck out. Al McInnes with it to Chris Pronger. Pronger and McInnes exchanging passes as we approach the four-minute mark. The Blues trying to change. Almost had too many men on the ice.
Got
in fact,
lucky.
Not almost did. They did.
Yeah, got
and
lucky.
Wings changing also. Wings clear the puck out. Knock loose for Demitra with Courtnall. Demitra can't get around Rouse. Draper clears off the boards, and Eiserman slaps the puck off the glass, and it'll trickle out to center ice. McAlpine takes the pass from Bergevin. He'll rifle the puck back in. Far side. Malfi gets hit. Rouse with a puck. He'll flip it out of play up into the crowd. And the action comes to a halt with 4:25 gone. No score first period. The Blues have three of the first four shots on goal.
Well, and certainly the Blues game plan really hasn't changed in this series. They want to continue to come out and hit, which they are doing in this game. We talk about the forecheck. They feel that they can cycle the puck down low when they get the good forecheck going. And a thing that's been talked about obviously a lot in the last few days, stay out of the penalty box, play even. When you think back to game number three, Detroit had 10 scoring chances in game number three, and only three of those were even strength. The other seven were on the power play.
There's no question if the Blues can play more five on five, they've already shown they can have more success. We've got a little problem down on the ice there in the corner, and that'll have to be taken care of. Game number five will be Friday night at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. That'll be a 6:30 Central Daylight Time start. We'll have that game for you right back here on Fox Sports Midwest. Game six, if needed, will be here in St. Louis next Sunday on Fox Channel 2 at 1. We'll have the play-by-play on radio. And if there's a game seven, it'll be on Tuesday the 27th, a week from tonight in Detroit.
Well, and now in Chicago tonight, Tony Amonte has scored his first goal of the playoffs as Chicago has taken a 1-0 lead over Colorado. Boy, what a game they played Sunday. All the injuries, their top three centers all out of the lineup. Craven, Zamnoff is out for the series, and Brent Sutter re-injured a knee. They brought up Dubinsky from the minors, and Denny Savard, who hasn't played much all season, played about half the game, and it was just a hard-working effort by Chicago to get back in the series.
A linesman trying to fix the ice there in the corner, and we check in with our pal Rob Ramage.
Well, thanks, Kenny. You know, before the game, we talked about all the ice time the big three are getting for the Blues, McGinnis, Pronger, and Bergevin. Well, already so far this game, Chris McAlpine's seen three shifts, and Pearson's seen one. So that's going to help spell those guys back on the blue line. Hopefully, we'll get some offense from McGinnis and Pronger now. Let's go back upstairs.
Yeah, pardon me, Ken, but what sometimes makes it difficult is now you're forced to play, even though Bergevin has had experience playing both the left and the right side, but Al McInnes has basically played right defense all season long. He's going to end up playing a lot of time on the left side. The same with Pronger. Pronger came up. He played junior hockey, was a left defenseman. When he came up with Hartford, he was a left defenseman before being switched to the right side. So he's got a little bit more experience playing the other side. But again, it is an adjustment for those players to play out of position.
Spending a lot of time trying to repair the ice there in the corner.
I think Mike Vernon pointed that out. He seemed to be the first one to get the attention of the officials to go over, and they spent quite a bit of time fixing the ice in that corner. Well, Mike Vernon has played well, hasn't he? Grant Fuhr, what a goaltending battle we have seen between these two great players who have battled and battled since they were in junior hockey. Grant Fuhr holds the edge in playoff hockey, though, over Mike Vernon with 11 wins and 9 losses. Vernon is 9-10 against Grant Fuhr in the playoffs.
They're ready to resume action. Then Mark Fawcett, the referee, getting in position. He had visited with Scotty Bowman. We're still early. First period, no score. We have not seen a penalty. Pronger with a puck at the blue line. Keeps it in. Quick shot, York. And it goes off over the top of the net. Larionov gets hit. Then Pellerin bumps him after the York hit. Oh, what a hit by Ward on Joe Murphy, who gets up, has the puck, works behind the net. York trying to center with Murphy, can't. LaPointe leaves the puck for Larry Murphy, up to Larionov, to LaPointe, back to Larionov. His feed is to Shanahan. Brendan Shanahan with a puck, getting booed. That started here in game three on Sunday. Pronger around far side. Shanahan there to the point. Larry Murphy for Detroit. The shot hits Harry York. Quickly back to get the puck is Nicholas Lidstrom. And both teams are changing. 5-12 play. No score. First period. Detroit has had only one shot on goal. And the wings. Nicholas Lidstrom with a puck ahead to Kozlov. Pronger breaks that play up, and it's offside as Sandstrom moves in. Fedorov was in over the blue line ahead of the puck.
Another good job by Chris Pronger, just anticipating the play, stepping up, and Detroit thus far has not been able to use their speed and really to an advantage against the Blues because of all the neutral zone we're seeing. Meanwhile, the Blues on a couple of occasions have had their forecheck going. They've gone in, they've played physical, they're taking the man. Here's Harry York going into the corner against Larionov, a player that they want to continue to hit. And there you see Aaron Ward coming in, a good hit on Murphy.
Detroit controlling the puck. Lidstrom's pass ahead, too far for Fedorov. Right to Fuhr. Here's Bergevin. On with McAlpine, Demitra, Courtnall, and Hull. The four players by for the puck in the corner. Demitra doing a little bumping, getting away. Sandstrom trying to get in front, then Hull steals the puck. Hull, a pass over to McAlpine. He gets to the red line. Ahead to Courtnall, right, and he shoots. He scores! Geoff Courtnall! Oh, baby, what a pass from Chris McAlpine. And the Blues take the lead here in game number four.
This all starts with a great defensive play in the Blues end. Just when it looked like Detroit was going to make the play, Demitra makes a defensive play on Sandstrom. Brett Hull helps him out, and then what a pass right there up the middle. And there's Courtnall, the quick shot, beat Vernon over the glove. Good play by McAlpine, taking the pass from Hull, and perfectly to Courtnall. Look at the quick wrist shot over the glove of Mike Vernon, and the Blues lead this game 1-0. Great shot. That stick coming into play by Sandstrom might have distracted Vernon a little bit. You can see the stick blade coming right into the blade of Geoff Courtnall just as he was shooting. That might have distracted Vernon. The Blues lead it.
There's a long shot by Draper and a blocker save by Fuhr. Bergevin trying to clear the puck out. Draper keeps it in as he and Peluso collide. Now the wings shoot the puck in and it's offside. The great assist for Chris McAlpine, his first in Stanley Cup playoff action in his second playoff game. Second goal of the playoffs for Geoff Courtnall, and Brett Hull, who gets an assist starting that play, now has 5 points in four playoff games.
All right, good defensive play by Pavol Demitra, and then what a wonderful pass from Chris McAlpine. Perfect. On the stick, and there's Courtnall. See the stick come in there? That was Sandstrom's stick that came in there, and it might have thrown the shot off a little bit. It might have distracted Vernon, but Courtnall just used his strength to shoot right through the stick and to beat Vernon.
5:50 is the time of the goal here in the first period. Detroit shoots the puck in from their side of center. Malpe sending it in front. McAlpine plays it. Not out, kept in by Pusher. And the Blues try to work out. Campbell can't stop by Pusher. The puck high in the air over the glass. And out of play, and we'll have a faceoff with the Blues out shooting Detroit 5-3 and leading it 1-0.
Now, Geoff Courtnall, of course, has taken a lot of criticism in the last couple of days for what happened in game number three, but he was ready to come out and atone for that penalty he took in game number three. And boy, what a wrist shot he let go. Here it is again. That's that's Demitra on Sandstrom. And then Brett Hull helping out. Boy, that's just a wonderful play, starting with what looked like was going to be a scoring chance for Thomas Sandstrom. It almost looked like he was going to walk out all alone, and Demitra recovered to make the good defensive play with the stick. And then the Blues quickly turned it the other way for a goal.
McKinnis gives the puck to Pronger. He'll clear it out, and it deflects off Larry Murphy into the Blues bench. Mateau is on left wing here. Conroy is in the middle, and Leach on this line is playing right wing.
Well, we're going to see Joe Quenneville make a lot of different changes, because with Turgeon out of the lineup, and we certainly hope that he is feeling better, but with him out of the lineup, it takes away a lot of offense. It takes away that offensive threat. So he's going to need one of his young centermen to step up, or a couple of them to step up and do the job.
McCarty on with Fedorov and Yzerman. This is Fedorov against Pronger, centering. Fedorov taken down. McKinnis with a puck. Great pass to Mateau, but he can't handle it. Larry Murphy leaves the puck. Conroy picks it up, works in. He's got Leach in front. Off his skate, and the puck goes right to Vernon, who smothers it for a faceoff deep in the Detroit end. The Blues, Courtnall has scored at 5:50, and the Blues lead 1-0.
Young defenseman, watch the play by Chris Pronger. If you put the stick between the legs, the forward can't go anyplace. He does this and then finishes off. What a hit on Sergei Fedorov, sending a message early in this game.
There hasn't been a penalty, and the Blues lead 1-0. Larry Murphy stopped in the corner by Stefan Mateau, works behind the net. And then Larry Murphy recovers up to McCarty. Pronger keeps the puck in. Here's Mateau leaving the puck for Leach, but it's knocked away, not out. McKinnis screenshot, and Leach deflects the puck wide. Conroy from Mateau. In front is Leach. The puck fails to get there. And the wings, Fedorov gets it up on the wing to Darren McCarty. His pass stopped by McInnes. A wonderful start for the Blues. Leach hit it center ice. Fedorov drives the puck in over the net. Now moving in, taking a quick shot. The Red Wings. Fuhr makes the save and Martin LaPointe. Both teams looking to change. Leach flips the puck ahead. And it goes to the Detroit end. It's Lidstrom ahead to LaPointe. Now Shanahan takes the pass off his skate, flips the puck in wide. Fuhr out, drives it up the boards for Joe Murphy. Joe Murphy plays it around behind the net. Far side moving up on the play. The Red Wing defenseman Konstantinov. Here's a shot, and that's turned away as LaPointe lets it go. York and Konstantinov mixing it up. Konstantinov loses his helmet. Now McAlpine for the Blues to Harry York. York's going to circle, and the Blues are going to change to McAlpine. Back for York. He's slowed up, and this is Lidstrom for the Red Wings. A pass by Shanahan. Now McAlpine has to wait. He's got a man in over the blue line, York. That forces the Blues to regroup. Bergevin, who's played extremely well. In front to Pellerin, trying to get in. He's taken down, and there's no call. Both teams are changing. The crowd unhappy. Now Demitra centers, and Rouse intercepts. Pass up on the wing for Sandstrom. He'll flip the puck ahead out of Kozlov's reach. Pronger sends it back into the Detroit end as the teams are changing. Sandstrom trying to clear. Holy shot! And Vernon a little more alert than he was on Sunday on one of those long ones. Here's Detroit again. Larry Murphy, good forechecking by the Blues. And Detroit there again just forced to dump the puck out.
And Kenny, the other thing that's happening is that the referee, Mark Fawcett, is really letting these teams play. There's a lot of hitting going on when players don't have the puck, and he's letting that go.
Out of the net, Vernon to clear the puck away from Courtnall. Geoff Courtnall has the game's only goal. Larry Murphy intercepts. He's hit by Demitra. Hall there, so is Courtnall, and the puck cleared to the line and out to center ice, shot in offside by Rickard Pearson. The Blues offside, and we're coming up to the 10-minute mark in this first period, 1-0 Blues.
As I mentioned, we're seeing a lot of hitting, even away from the play. This is a play, Harry York just goes right through Konstantinov, and see the little punch? Now watch this, he'll rip his helmet off. Coming up here, away from the play, rips the helmet off. Konstantinov holding the stick. Now Mark Fawcett is watching a lot of this, and he's just letting these teams play. Of course, they have been instructed to take the or call the stick work, and this is a play. Boy, Scott Pellerin taken down by Bob Rouse, and again, play goes on.
Now from the neutral faceoff, Draper for Detroit wins the draw from Petrovicki, then can't control the puck, and McInnes will blast it in. McInnes and Bergevin, Petrovicki, Peluso, and Campbell. Peluso's shot stopped by Vernon. Draper can't clear. Blues keep it in. This is Campbell. Lidstrom on top of Jim Campbell. Lidstrom pins Campbell to the board. Peluso there with Draper. And the Wings try to get out and do. The pass ahead to Kirk Maltby. Boy, look at McInnes really standing up at the red line. Not only his blue line. And the Blues really dominating here. This is Petrovicki flipping the puck in. They've outshot Detroit 8-4, and they lead it 1-0. Good part of this period owned by the Blues. 10-15 gone. Now Maltby stopped by McKinnis. And the Wings are changing. The Blues look to change.
Kenny, none of those four shots, I would say that Detroit has not had a scoring chance as of yet.
It's difficult to remember the shots, so they really have had a few, if any, and I would agree with you, probably no real good scoring chances. Jamie Pusher, the young defenseman, backhands the puck in. Twist working over LaPointe in front of the Blues bench, and Twist will hop over the boards. Larionov gets the puck for Detroit, keeps it into Shanahan, a man in front, the pass, and the backhander by LaPointe wide. LaPointe tied up by Pronger. York up the boards for Pellerin, and he'll clear the puck out off Pusher to Joe Murphy. Joe Murphy tripped by Larionov, and there'll be a penalty call here against Igor Larionov, and the crowd on its feet and roaring. The Blues will have the game's first power play. They lead it 1-0.
The circle player is Chris McAlpine. Shanahan has a lot of room, but watch a defensive play. McAlpine with his stick and then using his upper body strength, and Shanahan has to try and one-hand the puck across. And after that defensive play, here's Larionov tripping down Joe Murphy, who had some speed in trying to gain the line. The Blues have the first power play.
11:04, the time of the tripping penalty against Igor Larionov. Like the Wings, the Blues in this series, 2 for 23 on the power play. The Blues have McInnes, Pronger, Hall, Murphy, and Demitra.
And the Blues power play, again, Joe Quenneville has liked the amount of time that they've handled the puck, but he says they need to hit the net more with their shot.
This is Pronger, McInnes, Pronger, hauls over in the left wing circle, the far side. Now in deep in the corner. This is Demitra. Murphy is in the near corner. Hall goes to the front of the net. McInnes' shot blocked by Tomas Sandstrom, who is on with Iserman. They're replaced now on defense, Lidstrom and Konstantinov. Fedorov is up front with Draper killing the penalty for the Wings. And the puck is touched, and it's an icing call against the Blues. They failed to reach the red line when shooting the puck in. 1:19 left in the Blues' man advantage. They lead 1-0.
And what makes it difficult is you see the two Detroit forwards. They play up high on the Blues' defensemen. Yeah, now the Blues get control. Now watch the forwards, how high they play. So the Blues are trying to move the puck around, and they're really trying to prevent them from shooting. So there's, if we stop it there, there's some open area over here and on this side over here. If they can work the puck down low and then charge the net, they might get some chances. Here it is here. This is Demitra ends up with it, but again, the one shot was blocked by Detroit.
Joe Murphy, shy of the red line again, shoots the puck in. Vernon really shouldn't have played it. It would have been icing. Now McInnes trying to keep it in, can't. And the puck cleared out. Konstantinov, I think, gave him a bit of a butt end, and McInnes gave him a shove back.
Yeah, you're right.
Now the Blues, under a minute to go in their power play. McInnes grabbing onto the stick of Fedorov. Lidstrom intercepts, flips the puck in, and both clubs are going to change. We're down to 7:40 to go in the first period. Geoff Courtnall has scored the game's only goal. He has the puck. Out of Hall, dropping it for Demitra, and the puck comes out to center ice. Pronger with it. Over to Rickard Pearson, back to Pronger. Half a minute to go in the Larionov penalty, the first of the game. As Demitra shoots it in, Vernon leaves the puck for Rouse. He's on defense with Pusher, Sandstrom and Iserman up front. And they're about to be replaced. Both teams are changing. And the Larionov will be out in 15 seconds. Blues shooting the puck in again, and the Wings clearing it out again. So the Blues had set up earlier there, had a chance on the power play, but since the very early going, have not been allowed to do much. Jamie Pusher again fires the puck the length of the ice, and the penalty to Igor Larionov is over.
Well, when you shoot the puck in, which the Blues are being forced to do the second half of this power play, you've got to get in on it right away and not let Vernon handle the puck.
LaPointe takes the pass from Shanahan. Blocker saved by Fuhr. Shanahan a drive from the corner. Fuhr gloves the puck and shoves LaPointe away. And we'll have a faceoff near Grant Fuhr with 6:42 remaining in the first period.
And again, the Blues doing a good job keeping the puck to the outside, something they did well in game number one. There's the long shot by LaPointe. That's an easy save for Fuhr, as is this one from the far corner from Brendan Shanahan. If you can keep those shots from well out, Grant Fuhr is going to have an easy time of it.
The Blues have a 1-0 lead. Our best wishes to Christian Schickedans and all his pals at Bob Schultz Motorcycles. Ken Wilson, Joe Micheletti, Rob Ramage, first period. The Blues out shooting Detroit 8-6. LaPointe on the wing with Larionov and Shanahan. Larry Murphy and Aaron Ward on defense for the Wings. York and Larionov on this faceoff. York wins it. LaPointe all over Pronger. And McAlpine trying to get away from Larionov. Hands the puck to LaPointe. Centers. Shanahan! Oh, that one goes over the net. Oh, what a chance for Shanahan. Leads to Pronger. Up the boards for Pellerin. Now a nice pass, and it's just offside. Boy, very close, but York could not stay offside, or rather onside. So just offside of the faceoff back inside the St. Louis blue line. Our Pizza Hut, NHL leaderboard, points in the playoffs. And Brett Hull leads the club with 5. Courtnall and Turgeon with 2 each. Then Bergevin, Murphy, and McInnes, 1 each. Our Pizza Hut leaderboard, the Blues point scorers here in the first 4 games of this best of 7 playoff series.
Well, Brett Hull with 5, as you mentioned, Kenny. How about Sergei Fedorov? The first 3 games still without a point for Detroit.
That's an upset. Now Pronger to Steve Leach. Leach with a puck, trying to get it to Conroy, unable to, and Kozlov takes over for Detroit. To Fedorov. Line pass off of Pronger, who ends up with a puck. He'll shoot it in. Vernon out of the crease. Hands the puck to Leach. He centers. Oh, and it skips away from Twist. And it's shot out by Rouse. Twist is out there with Leach and Conroy. We've seen comparatively quite a bit of Twist here in the first period. McInnes feeds the puck in. Jamie Pusher will go back, and the Blues are changing. So Pusher has a lot of time to move the puck to Fedorov. There's a nifty move. And he loses it to Courtnall. He looks for Hall immediately, and the puck hops over Brett's stick. Pass back for Courtnall. Now to Demitra. Out to the point. Here's Bergevin. And the shot turned away. Deflected well away from the net. Kozlov for Detroit sends the puck high in the air. And Bergevin has to skate back for it as the wings are changing. 5:10 remaining. First period. Here's Brett Hall. He'll flip the puck ahead for Demitra. He and Konstantinov into the corner. Loose puck now for Courtnall. He's tied up by Sandstrom, who loses his stick. Bergevin keeps it in. Courtnall knocked down by Sandstrom without a stick, and Draper clears the puck out for the Red Wings. It's 1-0 Blues. They trail in the series, 2-1. Good play by Bergevin, and here's Pavol Demitra for the puck. Boy, you'd wonder where the Blues would be without the great play of Bergevin in the first three games and again tonight. Long shot by McInnes, wide from his side of the red line, and it's an icing call against the Blues. 4:33 remaining, first period, 1-0 Blues. Here's our Sitco What's on Tap tonight. In the first intermission, Geoff Courtnall will talk about his goal with Rob Ramage, and Larry Murphy will be Rob's guest in the second intermission with plenty of scores and highlights. Blues up 1-0. Conroy wins the faceoff from Shanahan. Pellerin takes the puck from Pronger, can't get it out initially, then Pronger picks it up. He'll fire the puck in. Larry Murphy and Joe Murphy into the corner. And up the boards it comes to LaPointe. Now to Larionov. He's got Shanahan on the near wing. Pronger intercepts, shoots the puck in. It's Joe Murphy, bumped by Aaron Ward. Larionov up to LaPointe, bouncing puck. And finally, LaPointe settles it down and rifles it in. Shanahan wrestled down by McAlpine. And the puck battled for along the board. Shanahan takes a shot, hits the post. Now LaPointe knocked down, and York breaks out. Player hurt behind the play, LaPointe. This is Joe Murphy in front for York. The puck out of his reach. Centering effort knocked away. LaPointe finally gets up and goes to the Detroit bench. Here's Brendan Shanahan winding her up. Long shot, Fuhr the save. And the rebound, Bergevin leaves it for McInnes. 3.5 minutes to go in the first period. Pusher for Detroit plays it back into the Blues end. McInnes clears it out. The Blues have the lead, 1-0. Campbell steers the puck to Petrovicki. He'll flip it in. It's Campbell and Peluso with Petrovicki. Now the puck controlled by Peluso to McInnes. The shot, and it deflects a couple of times, high and wide. Campbell for the Blues in the corner with Pusher. Pusher a pass up from Koser, and he'll clear it out. This is Mike Peluso for the Blues. As the wings begin to change, Campbell fires the puck in. The Blues are changing. Bob Rouse, the Detroit defenseman, to Kurt Malpe. He slaps the puck ahead. McAlpine gloves it down, fires it in. 2:45 to go. First period, the crowd very much into it. The Blues have a 1-0 lead. Konstantinov, right wing to Fedorov. Leach is on Fedorov. Leach stays with him. Good job by Leach. Now Yzerman behind the net to McCarty. Centering, hitting Fuhr in the side of the net. Up the ice, Conroy leads the rush to Pronger. He'll flip the puck high in the air, and it's offside. That's a tough call for a linesman. Just barely offside, trying to eye the puck high in the air, and the players heading in over the blue line.
Well, Brendan Shanahan, of course, has one of the quickest releases in the game. He just stays in the zone. There it is. Larionov gives it to him. Now watch the quick release. Lets it go quickly and just off the near post and out the other way. Here it is again. There's Grant Fuhr, perfect position, but you can see the velocity on the shot. by Shanahan. Got it off quickly with a lot on it, just off the post and out the other way.
Now they face off in the center ice area. You see Shanahan's career playoff numbers. Courtnall has the only goal of the period. It came at 5:50, McAlpine and Hall assisting. Bergevin has the puck. He'll play it to the line. Lidstrom for Detroit. Oh, ahead off the stick of Fedorov. He goes into the corner. Now to McCarty. He takes a bump from the goal. And quite a crowd. But McCarty ends up with a puck. Back to Bob Routes. He has trouble. Then he and Leach vie for it. Fedorov there looking for it. And Fedorov has it and shoots it wide. 1:47 to go. Big hit by Bergevin. He just barrels in with his shoulder, taking down Iserman, and the puck back into the Detroit zone with the two teams changing.
And the Blues have definitely outhit Detroit in this game. Thus far, they are hitting everything at every chance.
Quick shot by Sandstrom over the net. Puck centered, knocked away. Larionov on the first setup, and here on the second setup of Sandstrom. That's the toughest save Fuhr's had, and the Blues clear the puck out. Sandstrom has it to Konstantinov. Now to Pusher, it gets away. Hull with a puck. Hull comes in front. Hull a backhand to the save. Rebound, score! Demitra right there. Hull does all the work, and the Blues have the lead 2-0.
And they're going to go upstairs right away. Referee Mark Fawcett went right to the penalty box, and he was pointing upstairs. Demitra was in closest. The Blues, after a good defensive play, take control of the puck because Detroit gives it away. Watch Demitra in front. Here's Hull with the play. Here it is again. There's the shot. Oh, no question about it. That goal is going to count. Without question, that'll count because no one was in the crease. Look at the puck. It stays in. Then Demitra goes after it. That goal will count, folks. And it's up on the board now.
Boy, Pavol Demitra gets a huge goal.
And that was after a good save by Grant Fuhr on Thomas Sandstrom, and then the giveaway by Detroit at their own blue line. And again, the Blues, what they want to do in this series is counter offensively when they break up plays. And they did that. What a play by Brett Hull. Going to the net, holding on to it. Everyone thought he was going to shoot. Held on to it, went to his backhand. Vernon made one good save. And Demitra, with that nose for the net, headed right for the crease and put it into the empty net.
Demitra now has a goal and an assist, his first playoff goal. How about Brett Hull? What a series he's having. Here's Detroit. Fuhr makes the save on Kosar. Hull has assisted on both goals in this game. He has a goal and five assists in the first four games of the playoffs. So he's been involved in 6 of the 7 Blues goals. Now the Blues are called for icing. We're down to 46 and a half seconds remaining. The first goal, Courtnall from McAlpine and Hall at 5:50. Now Demitra from Hall at 18:51. Blues fans, enjoy tonight's game with a cold Bud Ice or Bud Ice Light. The official beer sponsors of the NHL. Drink Bud Ice, but beware the Penguins.
Now here's the Blues and Brett Hull. What a play after the giveaway by Konstantinov, who had the puck just inside his own blue line. He made a bad pass across to Lidstrom. And the Blues quickly jumped on the loose puck, and there was Brett Hull showing a burst of speed, the good move in tight, and then no one picking up Demitra, who put it into the empty net. What a start.
The Blues with a 2-0 lead, and in this series, a 2-0 lead is commanding. It's been that tight a series. We've rarely been in situations where it hasn't been a one goal differential.
Yeah, and there's been one penalty in this first period, just the one penalty to Detroit. There's been a lot of hitting, but very noticeable that all the sticks are down. They're low because that's what they're calling in the playoffs. Any stick infraction, they're calling. But there's been a lot of body checks and a lot of intensity in this first period.
The shots favoring the Blues, 10-9. They lead 2-0. Conroy and Eisenman back to the point. Larry Murphy, too much of a crowd, and eventually his shot blocked by Conroy, sliding the puck behind the net. After it is McInnes. But the Wings have it. Eisenman, good play to Shanahan in the slot. Murphy! And his drive wide, the staring effort by LaPointe. The puck comes to the blue line and out to center ice. 24 seconds to go. here in the first period. Eiserman shooting the puck in, and McInnes has it. Over to Pronger. Conroy, Pronger, and Murphy up front. Joe Murphy gives the puck to McInnes. The Blues, thank you. They settle for a 2-0 lead going to the dressing room. 10 seconds to go. McInnes flips the puck to Vernon. He'll have to hold on. And with 5.8 seconds left, we'll have a faceoff deep in the Detroit zone.
You talk about pressure situations for young, inexperienced players. How about Craig Conroy? Joe Quenneville in this game is using him for every important faceoff. He puts them out for a defensive zone faceoff in their own end, and then Conroy leaves the ice. In game number three, Conroy was their best faceoff man. He won 14 faceoffs, lost 9, and the Blues overall won 38, lost 35. But the key faceoffs, the youngster, the inexperienced Craig Conroy, has been out there, and he is one of those players that is having quite a series.
Early in the season, he was playing in the American Hockey League. In fact, the fella he so efficiently kills penalties with most of the time, Scott Pellerin, he was in the American Hockey League early in the season also. For this faceoff, Tony Twist is out there. Now, Mark Fawcett and Gerard Gauthier, Fawcett the referee, Gauthier one of the linesmen over at the officials' box at the penalty box area.
Well, I think Joe Quenneville is doing a couple of things here. Of course, Tony Twist is difficult to move from the front of the net. So if they win the faceoff, he'll go to the front of the net. The second thing is, with the Red Wings trailing 2-0 at the end of this period, I think Twist is on the ice just to make sure that everything remains calm.
Mark Fawcett explaining something to both coaches, Scotty Bowman and Joel Quenneville, and it has to do with the clock, and they're going to change the clock from 5.8 to 7.6. So they've added some time.
Well, which is certainly to the benefit of the Blues here.
I felt the same way. Good news.
Yeah.
Face-off is near Vernon. It's
now,
not
if it's
at the
other end.
Yeah.
It's a
you
bad deal.
Want it. So they drop the puck. York tied up by Fedorov. They still battle, and the Wings control. 1 second to go. Long shot. Caught by Fuhr, and that'll do it. What a start for the Blues here tonight in game number 4. They desperately need a win, and Geoff Courtnall and Pavol Demitra score in the first period. Coming up in the intermission, Rob Ramage will visit with first period goal scorer Geoff Courtnall. Scores and highlights also coming up. The Blues outshoot Detroit 10-9. After one, they lead it 2-0. The Blues on Fox Sports Midwest, brought to you by Hardee's. What will they think of next? By Boatman's Bank. Boatman's home equity credit lines are the smart way to get money. By the Discover Card, proud sponsor of the Smithsonian's 150th anniversary. And by Campbell's Chunky, soup that eats like a meal. The Blues lead it 2-0. Geoff Courtnall scored the first goal of the game, and he is downstairs with Rob Ramage.
Well, thanks a lot, Ken. Geoff, game of emotions. First game, you're a hero. Last game, your early exit. Tonight, first goal. It's going great.
Yeah, it's, you know, exciting time of year. Sometimes you get a little bit too revved up, and unfortunately, last game, I let my emotions get in the way, and it's nice to come back tonight and get a goal early.
Well, a totally different game than Sunday. A lot of penalties in the first period and second period, for that matter, but tonight, Fawcett's really letting you guys play.
Yeah, I think that's a difference. Our team really suit the 5-on-5 style against these guys. They got a great power play, and they're great 4-on-4. So when it's a physical game like that, it gives us a great opportunity to get everybody in the game.
Well, it's always great to get off to a good start. Chris McElveen filling in, not playing a whole lot this series, made just a great pass to you.
Yeah, through the neutral zone, he's carrying it over the red line, snapped it right on the tape, and I was in, and two guys tried to close it off, but it was too late. I just got a quick shot away.
Where do you keep your peanut butter? Top shelf. Nice shot. Now, Pierre Turgeon not in the lineup tonight. Igor Kravchuk not in the lineup on the blue line. But you guys are certainly picking it up. You missed Pierre, but Pavel's done a nice job at the pivot.
Yeah, it's nice. He's come on the last 10 games and played great. He's got a lot of talent, and he's not a centerman, but he's filled in there quite well, and he gives Brett and I a lot of room.
Now, you've been known as an agitator. I guess I can speak for that personally over the years, but that seems to be how you're very successful. You get players off their game, and it seems to get you in the game even more.
Yeah, I think if I get a hit early or, I get hit, it seems to get me into the game, get me into the flow right away, and I seem to get more chances offensively and create more chances for my line mates. And if I can distract somebody in any way and get them off their game to give us an edge or an opportunity, that's what I'm out there trying to do.
Well, you do it well. Don't change. Good luck.
Thanks, Rob.
Let's go back upstairs to Ken.
Being our guest tonight, Geoff Courtnall receives a gift certificate to Krieger's Pub and Grill, St. Louis's neighborhood sports bar and grill. Visit one of their four locations, Chesterfield, Maryland Heights, Big Bend, and 141, and their new location now open in Warson Woods. Scores and highlights are coming up next after 20 minutes in Game 4. It's 2-0 Blues.
We're at the Kiel Center. It's Game 4 of the NHL Western Quarterfinals. Geoff Courtnall, Pavol Demitra both scored for the Blues and given them a 2-0 lead over the Detroit Red Wings. Tonight's NHL Notebook is brought to you by Boatman's Bank. Let's take a look at where the playoffs stand tonight. Colorado leads Chicago 2-1. Dallas is down 2-1 to Edmonton. And Anaheim leads Phoenix 2-1. Over in the East, New Jersey leads Montreal 2-0. Florida and the Rangers are all tied at 1 apiece. Philadelphia looking to end Mario Lemieux's career. They're up 3-0. And Buffalo leads Ottawa 2-1. Five other games going on tonight. New Jersey leads Montreal 4-3 in the second. Florida is leading the Rangers 3-2 after two. Over in the West, Colorado leads Chicago 2-1 after one. Dallas and Edmonton will be later, as will Anaheim and Phoenix. We'll be back with second period highlights right after this.
Game four moving to the second period, and the Blues lead the Red Wings 2-0. Ken Wilson, Joe Micheletti welcoming you back. Two players instrumental, Joe, in both goals. Pavol Demitra and Brett Hull. Let's look at goal one.
Well, and the first one starts with a defensive play. There's Demitra right there. Look what he's doing on Sandstrom. It looked like Sandstrom was going to get an opportunity to score. Brett Hull comes in to help out. And then what a pass coming up. Mikal Parn and Geoff Courtnall, a quick wrist shot. Sandstrom had gotten back and got his stick in there. But again, Courtnall, watch the quick shot. You'll see a stick come in right as Courtnall's shooting it. I think that threw Vernon off a little bit. Courtnall gets a lot on it, 1-0.
Demitra finishes this goal.
Yeah, Demitra with a good job. This is after Grant Fuhr makes a good save right there again on Sandstrom. And then the Blues are able to clear it. Now, on the play, Detroit has plenty of time. They move the puck around, but they give it away right here. Bad pass. They jump on the puck. That's Brett Hull. Uses his speed, fakes the wrist shot, goes to a backhand. Look at Demitra all alone on the other side, who puts it in to make it 2-0. There it is again. What a move by Hull. And then Demitra with the net for the nose, going right to the net to put it in.
Our Casino Queen first period scoring summary, 5:50. Courtnall's second playoff goal from McAlpine and Hull. Then Demitra, his first from Hull at 18:51. The shots favoring the Blues, 10-9. The teams are about ready to return to the ice for the second period. And the Blues lead it 2-0. The Blues on Fox Sports Midwest, brought to you by AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. By your Midwest GMC truck dealers, Bellman, Bomarito, and Rockland GMC. By Ameritech, your link to better communications. And by the Casino Queen, we know what floats your boat. Well, Big Brothers, Big Sisters, a sponsor of the National Hockey League in our annual charity golf Big Brothers, Big Sisters tournament coming up on Monday, June 2nd at beautiful Glen Echo Country Club tomorrow morning. Call that number, 314-361-5900, and you can play in that tournament. A wonderful charity. Also call that number if you'd like to be a Big Brother or a Big Sister. Monday, June 2nd, our annual golf tournament. We're underway, and the Blues have played very well so far. They have a 2-0 lead, and they have to keep after it. Both teams at full strength, only one penalty in that first period. Here's Larry Murphy flipping the puck in. McInnes and Shanahan after. Boy, that's a nice play by McInnes. Now the puck centered. It comes right to Fuhr off the stick of Shanahan, who was sent down heavily by a fellow by the name of Chris Pronger.
Well, it started all on a kind of an innocent-looking play, and then Leafs just kind of misses it here. They don't get to the loose puck, and Detroit very quickly moves it in front, and Shanahan didn't ever have real good control of the puck. Just reached out and deflected it before Chris Pronger came back. There it is again. You see him, he deflected it and then couldn't reach it. And then by that time, Chris Pronger had come back to do a good job on Brendan Shanahan,
who is playing with Yzerman and LaPointe. Murphy and Lidstrom are out there for Detroit at the blue line. The faceoff near Fuhr. We're in the first minute of the second period. 2-0 Blues. Conroy on the faceoff, and he loses it. Lidstrom can't get a full shot. Bergevin with a bouncing puck, able to clear it out. Bergevin and Pronger. Now Conroy trying to steal from Murphy. Has his stick held forever. Leach skates through to Mateau. Mateau with a punt to Conroy. Oh, he shoots wide. Here's Steve Leach for the Blues with Mateau and Conroy. The puck deflects away. Larry Murphy for Detroit. Trying to get to the red line, does. Hit by Mateau. Then it's Yzerman with a quick shot and a good save by Grant Fuhr. And he holds on to stop play 56 seconds into the second period.
Well, two good chances already in this second period. Here's the first one by Conroy. I'm not sure he expected this. Great pass. But the puck, you could see the puck, it was a little bit on edge. And Conroy ended up going over the net with it. And then Yzerman, who has a good wrist shot, ended up letting it go quickly. Here it is again. He had a little bit pressure from behind. Pronger coming over, but he let it go quickly. And Grant Fuhr solid in goal.
The Red Wings have already had two pretty good shots on Grant Fuhr here in the first minute of the second period. The fans sitting here, I'm sure, saying, hey, a long way to go yet, fellas. Keep it up. Keep up your play of the first period. Draper and Hall on the faceoff. Draper, Maltby, and McCarty for Detroit. With Pusher and Rouse. Here's Rouse. His slap shot. And it sails over the net. Pusher moves in. Now to Draper. He's slowed up by McInnes. They chase into the corner. McCarty there to the point to Rouse. Back around behind the net. And Pronger has the puck. Clears it up. Not out. Pusher fakes a shot. That pass knocked away. Maltby to McCarty. This is Darren McCarty centering all the way to the blue line. Jamie Pusher, a shot blocked by McInnes. Ahead to Hull with Demitra and Courtnall. Three wings back. The shot off Rouse wide. Demitra with a puck. Gets checked, gets slashed. And the puck up the boards to Maltby. He shovels it ahead to McCarty. Chris McAlpine back. Bouncing puck, and McInnes retreats to get it and clears it away. Down the ice, Vernon gets it away from Courtnall, clears it up the boards. Rouse getting the puck ahead to Fedorov. Now to Larion, off to Fedorov, moving in front. Oh, and Fuhr seemed to get just a piece of that. Boy, what a move by Fedorov on McAlpine. And the puck to Fedorov at center ice. Now over the line, Kozlov, and it's offside. Offside are the Detroit Red Wings at the St. Louis blue line.
Well, Fedorov makes this move look so easy. He's on his backhand, and what he does is he pushes the puck ahead and through the defenseman. Watch Fedorov. He'll just throw it and then go retrieve it. Uses his body to fend off the check. That's a great play by Fedorov. Watch him throw the puck to an area and then uses his body to protect the stick. And then he goes and gets the puck for the shot, and Grant Fuhr makes a good save.
That seemed to graze off the post. Fuhr getting just a piece of it, but Fedorov coming very close.
Sergei Fedorov, who's a restricted free agent at the end of this season.
Remember, he played defense in the first game, the only game Detroit didn't win. Fedorov is without a point in the first four games of the series. The Blues lead this one 2-0, looking to even the series at two wins aside. The Wings come out of their end. Konstantinov with Fedorov. Bergevin, the lone man back, and the return pass knocked away by Bergevin. Loose puck, Pronger and Fedorov in the corner. Pronger doing a little bit of holding. Boy, Detroit's had a great start here in the second period. Here's Larionov. He hates to shoot, but does, and Fuhr the save. Bergevin a pass for Bellerin. Now to Pronger. His feet ahead for Harry York. York in over the line. The puck into the corner. Konstantinov hits by Joe Murphy. Hit from behind. Then Batisov crushed by Pellerin, and the puck back at the Blues line. Batisov has not played much in this contest. Here's Igor Larionov over the line to Kozlov to LaPointe. And the puck now taken by Petrovicki and cleared up. Campbell spun around at center ice. The puck battled for. Petrovicki carries it in, but Peluso is just offside. Neither team has scored in the second through the first 3 minutes, 13 seconds.
Scotty Bowman had his five Russians on the ice for the first time in this game, and they move the puck quickly. See Pronger get caught pinching on the play. Now it's 2-on-1. Konstantinov and Fedorov and Mark Bergevin. What a defensive play by Bergevin. coming back to block the pass, and just prior to all that, what a hit by Scott Pellerin on Fetisov, who I think Kenny played his first shift.
Early in the second period, Peluso misses the hit on Lidstrom. LaPointe clears it out, the Blues control. Here's McInnes on defense with Pronger. Petrovicki, Peluso, and Campbell up front. Peluso back to the defense. The pass for Petrovicki, he's offside. The pass from in the Blues end over the checkered red line. And we'll have a faceoff in the Blues zone.
Now, this has been a different period for Detroit to start this. We've played a little over 3.5 minutes of this second period, and Detroit has had a few more chances than they had in the first period, where they are able, they've been able to skate up the puck and skate up the ice, pardon me, and move the puck and generate some scoring chances on Grant Fuhr.
Detroit's been able to freewheel a bit, and the Blues, when they've gotten the puck, have been checked and bodied and kept from really going far. So it looks a lot different than the first period. Conroy now out with Leach and Matteau, and Conroy quickly lifted for York. On defense, McAlpine and Pronger.
Now, and Scotty Bowman has changed his lines around, too. Conroy was playing against Larionov and Shanahan along with Leach on that side, but now Scotty Bowman has switched. He's moved Yzerman with Shanahan, so he puts York back against Yzerman, and Leach stays on Brendan Shanahan on the wing.
The puck comes out to center ice. Larry Murphy, the 36-year-old defenseman, over to the Swede, Nicholas Lidstrom. Yzerman gets knocked down. Loose puck. Shanahan and York collide. And McAlpine, trying to shoot it in, hits Shanahan. The puck comes to LaPointe. Back for Yzerman. McAlpine trying to steal, finally takes the man. That's a good idea. Here's the defenseman, Larry Murphy, hit by York. Pronger gets in the way of LaPointe, then Larry Murphy gets loose. To Shanahan, nice poke check by Matteau. Leach up the ice, knocks the puck down, and the play just onside. Oh, good pass, York, to Leach, and the backhander wide. McAlpine pinches in, flips the puck behind the Detroit net. Brendan Shanahan for the Wings. He uses his strength to get the puck to Larionov. Detroit on the attack. The drop pass, Yzerman over to Larry Murphy. Fuhr out, the puck centered and knocked away as York did a good job getting in the way of Kozlov. And Matteau shoots the puck the length of the ice, and it is icing against the Blues. And the Wings have come out and owned the early portion of this second period.
Now the Blues have yet to get a shot, even though that last rush, Leach ended up with a chance on the backhand. And there's Shanahan. Boy, what strength. Using his strength to get the puck up to Larionov, and then Detroit, again, with more time, more room. Larry Murphy elects not to shoot, but to throw it in front. And that time, the Blues did a good job. Everybody collapsing to the net. They just go right to the net. But look how much time they have and how much room. That's something they did not have in the first period. But the Blues that time just came back. They did a good job. Kozlov was coming to the net, but you'll see all these white sweaters, three of them in front, made it difficult for Kozlov to put it into the empty net.
Ready for the faceoff near Fuhr. And the puck comes to Grant Fuhr. McInnes has it, leaving it for Bergevin. They're teamed on defense. Feller is tied up by Konstantinov. Here's Larionov to Fetisov. He's in alone. He shoots. Fuhr, a great save. Fetisov in alone. They've got the five Russians out there. Now Fedorov back. He gets an arm around the stick of Conroy. Fetisov goes down. And Conroy getting cross-checked by Fedorov, has the puck. No one in front. Now Joe Murphy's there. The puck left for Pellerin. Pellerin behind the net, gets knocked down. Into the corner goes Conroy. Nice pass to Pellerin. And the Blues doing some good work. Konstantinov knocks the puck away. Joe Murphy leaves it in the corner for Pellerin. Fedorov intercepts. Now to Kozlov, and he'll clear it down the ice. Bergevin will skate back to touch it, and it'll be an icing call against Detroit.
And that last play by Detroit, Fetisov, I don't think he saw. He had Kozlov wide open on the other side. I mean, this turned into a 2-on-0. Joe Murphy was the only guy back. There's McInnes coming out. Now watch, Murphy will go down. This turns into a 2-on-0. And on the other side, wide open, was Kozlov. And Fetisov elected to try and beat Grant Fuhr. Here it is again. The Blues running around. Look at that. Four players on one side. Joe Murphy, the only one back. He's anticipating a pass. He made the dive, and Fetisov just stepped around him, and Kozlov wide open on the other side. And Grant Fuhr, what a great save on Slava Fetisov.
Coming up to the six-minute mark of the second period, there's Grant Fuhr's brilliant playoff record. The Blues lead it 2-0, looking to even the series at two wins aside. Tomas Sandstrom shoots the puck in on with Draper and McCarty. Gets his own shot that went in deep in the corner. And finally, the Blues clear the puck over the glass. And that'll force a faceoff near Grant Fuhr. The Blues just shy of the six-minute mark here in period two have not had a shot on Mike Vernon.
Now, the big line in the first period for the Blues was Geoff Courtnall on one side, Brett Hull, and Demitra. They scored both Blues goals. They were plus two, and McAlpine and Pronger were on defense for both of those goals as well. They had four of the 10 shots. They were the dominant line in the first period. But in this second period, it's been all Detroit. The Blues running around a little bit in their own zone, not playing well defensively. Detroit having more time to make plays, and they have turned those opportunities into some good scoring chances, and Grant Fuhr has had to be sharp.
The Blues had the urgency in the first period, but with a 2-0 lead, Detroit has played with much more urgency. The Blues clear the puck out. Hull, Demitra, and Courtnall with McInnes and Pronger. Pronger into the corner, ties up Draper. Sandstrom also on with McCarty on this line. And the puck knocked away, but not out by Pronger. He'll go into the corner. Draper tries to get position, but Pronger does. And the puck goes the length of the ice, but right to Vernon. The Blues have the 2-0 lead. Rouse hits Courtnall. Quick pass to Hull. And the puck stolen by Rouse and at the red line taken by Iserman. Moving in on Pronger. He gets around him. And the backhander wide. And the Wings still with the puck. Sandstrom flips it behind the net. Here's Iserman. And McCarty bumps Pronger. Iserman gets a little room. Leaves the puck. Sends it behind the net. McInnes and Sandstrom there. Iserman taken down. The puck cleared out. And it's Larry Murphy for Detroit. Now the Wings are changing. Here is Nicholas Lidstrom. His pass ahead on the right wing to Iserman. He's tied up by Demitra, forced back in his own end, leaves the puck. Shanahan to Larry Murphy. Now the Blues are checking much more closely. Quick pass from Pronger to Joe Murphy. Ooh, to Demitra, and the puck hops over his stick. Big hit by Lapointe on Demitra. Then Lidstrom can't get the puck out, and Murphy has to retreat. Chased by Joe Murphy in the near corner. Mattel bumps Lapointe. The Blues play much better here in the last minute or so. Now the Wings break out. Lidstrom, right wing for Shanahan, stopped by McAlpine, who loses the puck. Here's Bartan Lapointe for Detroit as the teams are changing. His pass to Konstantinov. He'll feed the puck off the end boards right in front. And Bergevin knocks it away. Fetisov to Lapointe. Now all of a sudden the Wings are dangerous again. Fedorov and McAlpine. Shanahan there looking for a loose puck. He and York right there. Shanahan gets the puck, feeds it in front. Mateau takes over and breaks out. Mateau leads the Blues rush. Both teams changing. Quick shot caught by Vernon. Mateau taken heavily down by Fetisov. Pass to Fetisov from Larionov. Detroit now trying to work in. They do. And Bergevin breaks up the play. 8:16 gone here in the second period. The period is scoreless. Kozlov works in. Fuhr the save. Larionov drops the puck. Fedorov a drive that deflects wide. Larionov behind the net. The puck chopped to the corner. It's Sergei Fedorov for Detroit. Now to Konstantinov. Larionov ends up with a puck. He can't get a shot. Gives it to Fetisov. The five Russians. Kozlov the shot block. Now Larionov over to Fedorov. Is this control of the puck? To Konstantinov, back to Fedorov. He'll shoot, and the shot blocked. Ben Bergevin trips the Red Wing. That's Kozlov screaming, and Pellerin breaks out. Pellerin with York and Leach. Pellerin a drive, and that goes wide. York on the far side decides he better get off. Not quite sure about the change. Better safe than sorry. And away from the puck, Kozlov is knocked down, and there'll be a penalty called here.
There's Al McInnes, the right side of your screen. Now watch McInnes away from the play. He'll just trip down Kozlov. There it is right there. Trips him down. That's the penalty, and the Red Wings will have their first power play of the game. Boy, when they get going, this five-some of Russians, they can really get you running around. That's what the Blues were doing. instead of staying in your position, they start chasing the puck. And what the five Russians do so well is they all five continue to move into the openings. And you've got to play your position, take the man, and then stay with him and take him out of the play. It's tough to do.
9:06, second period, the penalty to McInnes, the Blues' first penalty of the game. Detroit 2-for-23 in the power play this series. This is a big opportunity for the Red Wings. They trail the Blues 2-0. Here's Larry Murphy. The pass for Shanahan. Iserman, Shanahan, and McCarty up front. Lidstrom at the far point. Murphy at the near point. Darren McCarty for Detroit. Trying to get the puck to Shanahan, and he can't. Then Shanahan and Pronger collide. Blues can't clear. Lidstrom ahead for Iserman, who knocks the puck down. Pronger gets it and blasts it the length of the ice. A minute 15 to go in Detroit's first power play of the game. Both teams changing. The Blues are up 2-0. And now 10 minutes remaining in the second period.
And Ken, what even makes it more difficult for the Blues is it's a defenseman, one of their top four, top three, that's in the box in Al McInnes.
Iserman to Kozloff, back for Iserman, knocked away by McAlpine. With the puck, Kozloff to Murphy, over to Lidstrom, wrist shot, and that's deflected over the net by Iserman. And Mateau able to clear the puck down the ice. Now Bergevin and McAlpine want to get to the bench. McAlpine can't make it. Pronger, McAlpine, Mateau, and Leach killing the penalty, and they stop the Wings there. Half a minute to go in the Detroit power play. This is Sergei Fedorov, Igor Larionov with Kozloff, Fetisov, and Konstantinov, and they're stopped there by the Blues. Both teams changing again. Konstantinov to Fedorov. He can't get around Pronger, and Konstantinov carries the puck in offside. Only 17 seconds remaining in Al McInnes' penalty.
Well, Mike Vernon also recognized what you did, Kenny. McAlpine having trouble getting off the ice. So as soon as the Blues cleared it, it was Vernon that came out of the net quickly, and McAlpine was going one way on his way to the bench. There you see McAlpine, 19. He's going right to the bench. Look at Vernon way out trying to catch the Blues in a line shift, but the Blues did a good job coming back, and Pronger stayed up on the play there before his teammate could get back in the play, and that play by Pronger forced the offside. Boy, McAlpine and Iserman were involved. Watch this. A little shot there. Another one coming up with a, and then Iserman comes right back and a little cross-check himself. All right, this has been a battle in front of the net.
2-0. Blues lead. Wings work in. Fetisov. Fedorov. The penalty just about over. Konstantinov into the corner. Larionov. McInnes is back on. Fedorov gets slashed by Pellerin. The puck to McInnes. He gets it to Conroy. He looks, sees what he has. 3-on-3. Now to Pellerin on his backhand. The pass for Conroy knocked away, and the Blues are changing. Here comes Detroit. Fedorov from Fetisov to Larionov, trying to get around McAlpine. The shot. Oh, what a save by Fuhr. And Pearson clears. Sandstrom a shot. Save, and McAlpine fires the puck into the Blues players bench. This has been a great second period for Detroit, but the Blues lead it 2-0.
Grant Fuhr received a standing ovation as we went to commercial. Here's why. Larionov, great move, and then the shot, and Grant Fuhr, excellent save before they can clear the puck out in front of him. And this is Sandstrom from a bad angle, but again, Grant Fuhr, perfect position, makes the save, and the fans here appreciate his work.
This game quite different than the first three, primarily because there have been only two penalties. How about Chicago? They won Sunday in double overtime. Second period at United Center tonight, they lead the Avalanche 3-2. So the Hawks, like the Blues, on their home ice, looking to even the best of seven series at two wins aside. Meanwhile, Florida in New York leads in the third 3-2. And the Devils in Montreal, 5-4 New Jersey in the third at Montreal.
In that game, Valerie Delapukhin with the hat trick for New Jersey.
Now Larry Murphy for the Red Wings to Nicholas Lidstrom. Up to Iserman, trying to move around Rickard Pearson. He's poke checked. Mateau gives the puck to Joe Murphy. Back to the point. Here's McInnes. The big shot. Skate save, Vernon. The puck loose. Vernon has it. York right there, finally getting knocked down by Shanahan, and Mateau there also. But what a brilliant save. Now Mateau giving Larry Murphy a couple of shoves, but a brilliant save by Mike Vernon.
Well, and this is what speed will do. Joe Murphy uses his speed to get all the Detroit players backing in, and then makes a nice pass back to the point to McInnes. Here it is again. Here's Murphy with the puck. Now everyone backs in, backs in, backs in. Perfect little pass right here. And then York is in front. Now one save, and York will get a stick on the puck right here. But it rolls right into Mike Vernon. He doesn't get much on it. Great shot from McInnes. Now watch the stick there. There it is by York. And then he is dumped by LaPointe after the play. York tough to move off. Brendan Shanahan is there in front. There's York getting his stick free. And then from behind, it was Martin LaPointe coming in to take him out.
Geoff Courtnall, Pavol Demitra scoring in the first period. Courtnall intercepts, centers, and the puck knocked away. Brendan Shanahan for Detroit clears it out. Back deep into the blue zone goes Chris McAlpine. He's on defense with Pronger. Demitra, Hall, and Courtnall up front. Hall has assisted on both Blues goals. Pronger up to Courtnall, and the puck deflects down the ice. This will be icing. Lidstrom back to touch it. And there's 7:29 to go in the second period. The Blues are up 2-0. Well, let's tell you about the Blues website, fans. To be certain, to really know what's up, you've got to visit the Blues' new site on the World Wide Web. The address right there, www.stlouisblues.com. There's nothing quite like the Blues website. We hope you'll visit.
And now Joel Quenneville really making a number of different changes. Demitra with a bad finger goes off. Brett Hull has been taking face-offs in his own end. And the people here are hooting and hollering and having a good old time.
If you've joined us late tonight, Igor Kravchuk, again, not playing a rib injury, as was the case Sunday afternoon. And Pierre Turgeon is out after suffering headaches. 1-0 Edmonton at home, leading Dallas. The Oilers looking to upset the Stars in their best of seven Western Conference quarterfinal series.
Yeah, Andrei Kovalenko gets the first goal of that game tonight. Edmonton trailed 3-0 with 4 minutes to go in the game and scored three quick ones and won it in overtime.
Also tonight, Phoenix at home against Anaheim, looking to even that series at 2-2. Bob Rouse over to Pusher. Oh, he drills it off the post. On Fuhr's stick side, he hits the post. Now Hall breaks in. Pusher back. Hall a shot. Vernon a save. And he holds on to the rebound. Both teams there in a matter of seconds with excellent scoring opportunities.
Well, Robert Petrovicki lost two faceoffs in the Blues end. And Detroit turned it into a scoring chance. There's Petrovicki losing the first one to Draper. And now a scoring chance. This one off the post. Quick shot off the post. There's Fuhr again. Watch it. Oh, wow. He got a lot on the shot. And then the Blues were able to come down the other way. Brett Hull came off the bench. And with the quick shot, tried to get Vernon to open the legs. And Vernon with a good save coming well out of his net to cut down the angle on Brett Hull.
The Blues have started to come back a bit here in the second period. They've had some chances. The early part of the period was all Detroit. And while the Blues have started to come back, Detroit's still getting chances.
Yeah, and Scotty Bowman staying with his Russian five-star.
Vernon there stopping McInnes. This Russian group has been terrific in this period. It's Fedorov in front. The shot blocked by McInnes. And the puck controlled and cleared out by Conroy. Man, they are really something to watch. You have to have some fear in your thoughts when you watch this Russian group out there.
Yeah, well, Konstantinov was on the ice for both Blues goals in the first period, and Scotty Bowman needed to make some changes, and thus far in the second, even though they haven't scored, they've worked. They're playing much better.
Here's Steve Leach. Left wing to Pellerin. Conroy to the net. Back to Leach. He's taken out by Fetisov. Carries into the corner. And then Fedorov gets the puck. To Fetisov. The Blues are changing. Fetisov to Larionov. They get the puck out there and they start passing it around. They'll do that for 10 minutes. 6:15 left. In the second, the Blues are up 2-0 as the wings are changing. McInnes off the boards to Pellerin. He'll flip the puck in. Glove down by Lidstrom. He's on with Larry Murphy. Shanahan, Eiserman, and LaPointe. Back to Larry Murphy. A slap shot off Bergevin's stick. And high into the crowd behind Grant Fuhr, down to 6 minutes to go in the second period, 2-0 Blues. Folks, Discover Card, on behalf of the Blues, is happy to make a donation of $500 to the Make-A-Wish Foundation for every hat trick scored by the Blues this season.
And now the Blackhawks have taken a 4-2 lead over the Colorado Avalanche. Bob Probert with a couple of goals in that game.
Wow. Colorado winning the first two at home, then Chicago trying to win two on their ice. The Blues won the first game in Detroit, then the Wings took game two, and the Wings won game three here in St. Louis Sunday afternoon. The Blues would love to get this victory and then have a simple best of three series. Games five and seven in Detroit. Game six, of course, will be right back here if needed next Sunday. Campbell dumped at center ice by Lidstrom. Larry Murphy with the puck. It's knocked away. The shot pass by Peluso off Campbell's stick. He leaves the punt for Petrovicki. Now to Mike Peluso. He's got Bergevin at the far, at the near point. Has to leave it at the far point, and the Wings take over. Lapointe. Lidstrom. Eiserman works in. The pass to Eiserman. Forced behind the net. Good work by Bergevin, and he smothers Eiserman. Then Shanahan and Pronger are there. Pronger gets the puck. Look at Pronger. Boy, does he play with confidence. Look at that. Just moves his arm, stay away from me, and flips it in like he owns the puck.
And Petrovicki might have gotten away with one, taking Shanahan out of the play while Pronger was handling the puck.
Hall has to wait for Peluso, who had a big hit moments ago, and the play is offside anyway. Offside are the Blues at the Detroit blue line. 5:06 to go in the second period. The Blues are up 2-0.
Well, Petrovicki first had come back. Now watch Petrovicki right there on Shanahan. He takes him out of the play. They both go down, but that gives Pronger enough room to then carry the puck, skate it out of his own zone. And you're right, you talk about confidence. Look at him skate. Again, we've mentioned it before. Joe Quenneville getting him to skate more. You've got room, you're a good skater, take the puck and make the plays, and boy, has he been doing that.
Nate and Dave here tonight. They want to say hi to the folks at the University of Missouri Rolla. Also a big hi to Steve Payer and Todd Neal from Toby and Kelly. The Blues have a 2-0 lead. Game four. The Wings with a punt. Kozlov. He is on with Fedorov and Larionov. And again, Konstantinov and Batisov. Konstantinov knocked down by Leach. And the puck played at the Detroit defense. This is Batisov to Larionov. They sometimes give you the idea that the puck is attached to their sticks. As Hull is stopped, Conroy the steal. Hull robbed by Vernon. Well, that's a big play by Vernon. Back the other way, Fedorov stopped. McGinnis standing up again out of the neutral zone. Boy, Detroit just giving you the thought that they can control the puck easily. And at that very moment, it's stolen by Conroy. Pusher now ahead to Kozlov, to Fedorov. Then Larionov steals after the Blues get possession. He falls down centers, and McGinnis takes over. Up to Brett Hull. Just over 4 minutes remaining in the second period. Right wing for Demitra. Vernon comes way out. Gives the puck to Kozlov. He can't clear. Courtnall bats it to Demitra. To Courtnall. In front for Hull. A puck deflects to Vernon, and he'll smother it. The Blues lead it 2-0 with 3:58 to go in the second period.
When the Russian Five are on the ice for Detroit, they'll make passes that they're not afraid to make, a lot of different types of passes, and this is the turnover, and Brett Hull ended up with the chance, and remember that save by Mike Vernon. He's made some key saves in the latter portion of this second period. Boy, one more goal to make it 3-0 could be a backbreaker for Detroit, and Vernon has been there to make the saves.
Now they puck in the Detroit end. Courtnall, Demitra to Courtnall. Geoff Courtnall has the two first period goal scorers. Demitra and Courtnall combined there. Pronger gets the puck, shoots it in. Pronger, McAlpine, Hall, Courtnall, and Demitra. Now ahead to McCarty. Taking the puck, Draper working in. Knocked away is the puck by Pronger. Draper gets it again. McAlpine slows him up. Pronger stays in front of the net as they battle along the boards. And Courtnall comes in front of the net also. That Pronger into the corner. Causes havoc for McCarty and gets the puck to Chris McAlpine. He's been exceptional Sunday and again tonight. Pavol Demitra dumps the puck in. Just over 3 minutes remaining in the second period as the Blues are changing. Jamie Fisher for Detroit. A pass too far for Iserman. This is McInnes. His pass is to Harry York. The wings changing to Courtnall. In front is Murphy. And Joe Murphy gets in a little too deep with LaPointe on his arm. And the puck cleared out by Detroit. Bergevin over to McInnes. 2:40 to go, second period. Neither team has scored in this period as the Blues shoot the puck in. It's 2-0 St. Louis. They need a win to tie the best of seven series at 2 aside. The pass for LaPointe too far, and this is Mark Bergevin. The shots now in this period are even at 9 aside. The Blues have had a great comeback. This has been somewhat wide open, relatively speaking. There have been a lot of scoring chances in a period that has been scoreless. LaPointe to Fedorov. Stop where? Right at the blue line. The Blues much better tonight, standing up at their own line and the playoff side. So that stops the action with 2:06 remaining here in the second period. And the Blues with a lead. Then York and Murphy bumping. Then York and Fedorov. York and Fedorov. They don't want to drop their sticks. And then Bergevin comes over to calm Harry York. One of the linesmen has Stefan Matteau corralled off to the side. Mark Fawcett, the referee, he has been very calm. He's basically been a spectator.
Yeah, now he just goes over to Stefan Matteau and says something to him. It looked like he was motioning about his stick to keep the stick down. And Fawcett continuing to have conversations. He's not going to call anything. He's done a good job in this game. He's let both teams play. There haven't been any high sticks. We've seen a lot of hits in this game. And Mark Fawcett, you're right, has kept cool and called a good game.
The Blues hockey tonight, it's not only exciting, it's brought to you by the official beer sponsors of the NHL. Great tasting Bud Ice and Bud Ice Light. Drink Bud Ice, but beware the Penguins. Boy, if it's 5-on-5 most of the time, that does nothing but favor the Blues. That's what they want. That's what they need. Konstantinov retreats to get the puck. He's on with Matisoff, Larionov, Kozlov, and Fedorov. They have been dominant here when they've been on together. Look at Larionov. Stopped again by the Blues at their line. Conroy to Pellerin. What a move. Can't get the puck in front to Leach, who'll dig it out of the corner. Tied up by Fedorov. Matisoff, nice pass to Kozlov. McInnes and Bergevin are back. Kozlov with a puck. Feeds it in front. No one there. Detroit is changing. And McInnes drives the puck off Sandstrom. Leach with it. His pass to McInnes. He'll blast the puck just wide. I think Vernon expected him to just shoot it in. At center ice, they vie for the puck. Murphy hit by Matteau. And Demetra shoots the puck in. Down to 1:08 remaining in the second period. The Blues getting 2 in the first. And they've maintained that lead. McAlpine collides at center ice with Iserman. And the puck shot in. Under 1 minute to go in the period. Pronger flips the puck out. Lidstrom gets in Demetra's way. Hands the puck to Hall. He shoots. And the shot goes wide. 45 seconds to go in the period. Here's Larry Murphy from Iserman. Working in. That Galpine takes him out. Pronger with a puck. Clears it up the board. It's Matteau with Hall. 2-on-2. And the pass gets by Hall. The puck shot in offside. And the whistle stops play. 31.9 seconds remaining as McAlpine and Larry Murphy exchange glares behind the Detroit net.
Yeah, and actually Sandstrom too. Sandstrom has been involved in this shift. First, he and Demitra came together on the boards. Look at, there's Sandstrom with Demitra. Now watch Demitra getting ready. He fakes like he's going to punch him and then decides not to. And then the play continues to move on. And on the other side of the ice, Sandstrom ended up with the puck and Demitra looked at that opportunity as I'm going to go right back after him. Here he comes. Bang. Right there. Demetra goes right back after him and looks at him and just to let him know that he was still on the ice.
Tomas Sandstrom will always play it physical. Pavol Demitra, not a big player, and he doesn't mind the rough going, does he?
I'll tell you what, he's a good hockey player. He has turned a lot of heads here in St. Louis with his play, not only with the puck, but away from the puck.
This second period has been scoreless. McInnes fires the puck in and it sails into the crowd 27.2 seconds to go.
And Kenny, this has been, and we've talked about this, more of a wide open period, but part of the reason for that is that Detroit has decided in the second period to take more chances. I mean, their defensemen have really tried to pinch in a lot and get aggressive offensively, and if you can get the puck past them along the boards, which the Blues have done on numerous occasions, they've been able to come back down 2-on-1 and had some odd man rushes. But Mike Vernon has held the fort for Detroit in the second half of this period. Grant Fuhr was brilliant in the first half of this period.
2-0 Blues. Neither team has scored in the period, but you're right. Detroit came out at the start of this period and said, hey, we're down 2-0. We're not going to wait to the third to get desperate. They started to play desperate here. Fuhr makes the save. 15 seconds to go in the period. Chris Pronger with a puck. He'll just send it in the air. Pusher will go back. And that's going to do it. There's going to be a penalty at the end of the period here. There's still some time left, and there'll be an elbowing penalty called against Detroit with 7 seconds remaining on the clock. Chris Draper will go to the penalty box.
I believe that that happened in the corner on Al MacInnis. When MacInnis was going back to get the puck, I believe Draper came in and got the elbow up. Here's MacInnis here, and here's Draper. Look at the elbow. That kind of, it kind of slid up MacInnis's shoulder. Looked like he kind of had his arm out, but slid up the shoulder and got a piece of him. And so Detroit ends up with the late penalty in this period.
If you'll bear with me, let me just say that given the way this game has been called and given some of the things we've seen, that's not much of a penalty. The Blues will take it.
But sure. I agree with you.
Not much of a penalty.
I do agree with you. I agree with you.
And Scotty Bowman had that look also.
Oh, we've seen that look.
It sort of looks happy, but it really isn't. 2-0 Blues. Petrovicki wins the draw. Back to Hall. Hall a shot. And it deflects off Pronger wide. 1 second remaining in front. Petrovicki. Oh, stopped by Vernon. Oh, what a save by Vernon right at the end of the second period.
When Petrovicki got the puck in front, there were less than 2 seconds to go. Watch this. Pronger just throw it in front. There it is. Less than a second. I think that would have counted. Vernon again with a good save to end this period.
Neither team scores in the second period, but it was a heck of a period of hockey. 10 shots aside. In this intermission, Rob Ramage will have as his guest Detroit defenseman Larry Murphy. We'll also have scores and highlights. After two, it's 2-0 Blues. This is game number 4, the best of 7 series. The Blues trail in the series 2-1, but Geoff Courtnall and Pavol Demitra have scored first period goals, and after two, the Blues are up 2-0. Larry Murphy gets a lot of ice time for Detroit, their veteran defenseman, and he's downstairs with Rob Ramage.
Well, thanks, Ken. Larry, last year at this time, you were embroiled in a battle with the St. Louis Blues, but you're playing for the Toronto Maple Leafs. A good deal for you getting out of there this year. They didn't make it. Now you're a Red Wing.
Yeah, it was obviously a great opportunity for me going from a team that was out of it to a team that was well in the playoffs. So it was probably the biggest jump in the standings I've ever been involved with, and I was more than happy.
Well, you've played for Scotty Bowman before, winning a Stanley Cup with Pittsburgh, so that might have had something to do with the deal.
Yeah, I'm sure he was well aware of what he was acquiring, and that's the advantage for him. He knew, you know, he had me personally, so he knew what he was getting, and I was pleased. I mean, we had success with him before, and hopefully it'll be the same way in Detroit.
Sunday's game, a very emotional game. A lot of minors, 16, I believe. Tonight, a totally different game. Only 3 minors called so far.
Yeah, it's taken off on a different look. That's what's what playoffs are all about, though. Every game seems to be different, and you can't really predict what's going to happen. I've been involved in games where you figured it was going to be 1-0, and it turns out to be 8-7. So you just got to be ready for anything, and tonight he's not calling too much, so that's an opportunity to get more players in the game.
Blues had a very good first period, but you guys really came out in the second, got some great scoring opportunities, and Sky elected to put the 5 Russians back together. You had a chance of playing defense with Fedorov for part of the season. How was that?
Well, they're obviously very talented players. Their system over there, they really concentrate on the fundamentals, and you can reflect on the players that are in this league that are from Russia. And These five are no different. They throw out a different look there, and they did create some opportunities. Grant Fuhr did a great job, obviously. I mean, he stopped everything that we threw at him.
Murph, thanks for joining us.
You're welcome, Rara.
Let's go back upstairs to Ken.
All right, guests on Blues Hockey receive a gift certificate to Hot Shots Bar and Grill. Hot Shots in St. Charles, Bridgeton, Manchester, and coming soon to South County. Well, scores and highlights coming up after two periods. The Blues lead it 2-0.
We're at the Kiel Center, and it's game four. Geoff Courtnall's goal in the first, as is Pavol Demitra's in the first, are holding up. After two, the Blues lead the Red Wings 2-0. On our Bud Ice out-of-town scoreboard tonight, Jersey's defeated Montreal 6-4. Florida and the Rangers are all tied up late in the third. Robitaille's just tied it for the Rangers. Colorado getting hammered by Chicago 5-2. Dallas and Edmonton all knotted up one apiece after one. And Anaheim Phoenix are just getting started. Well, we've got a great game going here. You got to love the way the Blues came out in the first period. But, you know, they played very strong, I thought, in the third period, Sunday against the Red Wings after two very poor periods to start the game. But you know what? They've got to keep going the way they are right now. They started, I thought, the second period rather poorly. They really rebounded, some great opportunities. Brett Hall's having a super game, the two assists, some great scoring chances. The defense is playing really well. Nice to see Chris McElpine help out. I think he's played about 18 shifts so far, so that should help the big three with a little bit of rest. Going into the third, the Blues lead 2-0. We'll be back with third period highlights right after this.
The Blues are well positioned to even this series of two wins aside as the game moves to the third period. Ken Wilson, Joe Micheletti welcoming you back. Well, we talked about it a lot. Many more scoring chances in the second period than the first. Let's start with Detroit, Sergei Fedorov.
Well, Scotty Bowman put the Russian five back together, and Fedorov shows great skill. Now, again, watch what he does. Throws the puck in an area, then uses his body to keep his stick free. And then Grant Fuhr has to come up with a save. Also got a little bit of help from the post.
Early Blues breakdowns in that period.
Yeah, and this is Murphy. Look, he's the only man back. Both defensemen are gone. Murphy anticipating a shot. That's Patisov that moves in from the point. Again, Grant Fuhr with a great save.
And as the Blues got into the period, they got some chances.
Yeah, good job on the forecheck, causing the turnover. Now, Brett Hull all alone, and Mike Vernon, we talked about him often. He comes up with a big save on Brett Hull.
And right in the last second or two, they almost score.
This is what the Blues on the power play. Watch in front of the net. Pronger will just throw it in front. All alone is 36. Petrovicki, there it is. Time took a little bit too much time. Vernon was able to come over and make the save.
Our second period summary is brought to you by your local Chrysler Plymouth dealers. There was no scoring in that period. The shots were even at 10 aside. Remember, there was a late penalty against Chris Draper. So the third period will begin with the Blues leading 2-0 and on the power play. The Blues on Fox Sports Midwest, brought to you by Discover Card, proud sponsor of the Smithsonian's 150th anniversary. By Jack in the Box Restaurants, watch out, Mac, Jack's back. By your neighborhood Chrysler Plymouth dealers. And by Southwest Airlines, with fares so low, you have the freedom to go places.
Now, Kenny, a much different second period as we talked about, and I think the one thing that was really apparent that stuck out was the lack of hitting in that second period. The first period, the Blues out-hit Detroit 9-6 for a total of 15 hits in the first period. That second period, there were only 6 hits. The Blues had 4 of those. So they need to get back to the hitting, and that, when they start hitting, it really prevents Detroit from getting that flow going, that offensive flow, and will really slow them down.
The Blues have the power play, only their second, only the third power play of the game. Konstantinov stops Pronger, the puck over to Yzerman in front and knocked away. What a play by McInnes as Sandstrom was moving in on the left wing. The puck ends up in the crowd.
Well, remember game two, it was a shorthanded goal that got Detroit back in the game by Chris Draper. This time the Blues give up the puck. Chris Pronger just overskates it, tries to hit, just deflected off the boards, and then very quickly Detroit comes the other way. What a play by Al McInnes. Yzerman kind of fakes the shot and tried to fake out McInnes at the time, but McInnes wouldn't go for the deke, and just dove into the passing lane with his stick to deflect the puck over the glass and break up the 2-on-1.
The Blues have the man advantage and a 2-0 lead, and the puck shot by Detroit all the way back to Vernon. Konstantinov, Lidstrom, and Sandstrom and Yzerman killing the penalty. Vladimir Konstantinov shoots the puck the length of the ice. And the Wings quickly change their penalty killing. 1:10 to go in this Blues man advantage. They haven't done much yet. Now Pronger from McInnes to Joe Murphy. He loses the puck, carries it in offside, and a delayed call. Fedorov. The puck knocked away by Demitra. He gets it, gives it to Petrovicki. And Pusher knocks it away. Here comes Pronger. Ahead to Demitra. Power play in front. Courtnall alone. He just scores! Geoff Courtnall! And a huge third period power play goal. And a 1:10. And the Blues have a commanding 3-0 lead here in game number 4.
And it all started in the neutral zone with Pavol Demitra anticipating getting hit, then leaving the puck. Chris Pronger, keep an eye on him, because he's going to fake a shot right here. Fake it, take the defenseman Pusher out of the way, and the perfect little pass, and boy, do the Blues move it quickly. There it is again. Look at Pronger. Instead of shooting, the perfect pass, and Demitra, head up, finds Courtnall, the quick shot by Courtnall, through the legs of Mike Vernon to make it 3-0. What a pass from Demitra. What a play from Pronger on the point. And this crowd is into it now as the Blues lead it 3-0.
Second goal of the night for Geoff Courtnall. Boy, has he made a recovery from that 5-minute penalty Sunday. Here comes Petrovicki. He's got Campbell near the net. The pass behind the goal. Campbell gets squished to the boards. And a battle in the corner. Petrovicki, Pusher, Draper, and Campbell. And here's Rouse with a puck. Demitra and Pronger assisting on Courtnall's goal. At 1:16, here's a shot, Fuhr the save, he gets hacked at, and Peluso is all over Maltby. Boy, I thought Maltby really slashed Fuhr, and Peluso charged in. I would think both would get a penalty.
You're absolutely right. I mean, Maltby took a big-time slash at Fuhr. Here's Maltby, 18, now watch the slash. Right there on the right arm, the right wrist. And Peluso came in, saw that. He does a good job coming in, but I think he'll get the only penalty. Here it is again. Watch Maltby. Look at the slash. Right there. Fuhr clearly had the puck and was freezing it. And Maltby, you can say, ended up drawing another penalty, something he's done a lot. Here it is again. Watch Pronger. Fake it. There's the defenseman coming out. Then the perfect little pass. Now Demitra has time and room. And puts the puck right over to Courtnall, wide open. You saw the defenseman Pusher. That's why there wasn't a defenseman in front of the net. He came way out to the point, got drawn out there. The other defenseman was on the other side. Brendan Shanahan, the forward, did not come back all the way quick enough to cover Geoff Courtnall. And Demitra with a wonderful pass, and Courtnall with a great finish.
1:44, Peluso gets the lone penalty. 2 minutes for roughing. Demitra has been involved in all 3 goals, has a goal and an assist. Courtnall has scored 2. Still a lot of time to go. Detroit 0-for-1 on the power play. The Blues must be disciplined. Here's Bergevin. Now to Conroy. McCarty tips the puck back. Played by Larionov. Conroy, Pellerin, Pronger, and Bergevin killing the penalty. Yzerman over to Shanahan, knocked away. And the Blues will change their penalty killing unit. Half a minute into the Detroit power play. Shanahan behind the back. Yzerman can't control. Leach clears the puck out. This is Larionov. Igor Larionov, 36 years of age. Now to Steve Yzerman, the veteran Detroit captain, shooting the puck in. Bergevin back. He's on with Pronger, Leach, and Mattel. The Blues clear the puck out. Coming up to the 3-minute mark of the third period, the Blues lead it 3-0. Shanahan with a puck, it slides right back to Vernon, and it's Larionov. Both teams are changing. Larionov headbanding to Yzerman. He winds it up, shoots the puck in, far side. Lapointe knocks it down. Pronger trying to clear up the boards, can't. Yzerman, Pronger, Lapointe, and McInnes. In the corner, Shanahan out to Lariano. Back to Shanahan. Shanahan shoots. Oh, and he shoots wide. He's got something on that one. Then Lidstrom to Lariano. Half a minute to go in the Blues penalty. They have a 3-0 lead. Here's Shanahan. He heads to the net. Gives the puck to Lariano, who doesn't like to shoot. Yzerman over to Lidstrom. He'll let it go. What a long save by Fuhr, the quickest glove in the West. Wow. What a save by Fuhr right there.
And look at these fans standing and applauding Grant Fuhr. Excellent puck movement by Detroit. And Lapointe in front trying to get position in front of Grant Fuhr. McInnes a little bit of a hold on the stick. And then look at Shanahan there as well. Good puck movement. Here comes the shot. Pellerin went down to block it. Shanahan jumped to get out of the way. And when all was said and done, the puck ended up in the great right glove of Grant Fuhr.
Mike Peluso is in the penalty box for another 17 seconds. Huge crowd enjoying this one at Kiel. Very few empty seats tonight in Detroit. And if the Blues win this one, that means we'll have a game six here Sunday. Petisov's shot knocked away, and Pellerin clears the puck the length of the ice. There'll be a penalty here. There'll be a penalty as referee Mark Fawcett stops play. It'll be Konstantinov, got his elbow up, I believe, on Pellerin.
Correct. Pellerin was going to clear it. Konstantinov just rushed in, and after Pellerin cleared it, he saw him coming. And he avoided most of it. Here it is again. Oh, yeah, look at the right elbow. Right up into the face of Pellerin. Pellerin turned and said something to him. Mark Fawcett made the call. And with the Blues in a 3-0 lead, Konstantinov doesn't like the call. Doesn't like our camera. Still doesn't like our camera.
Watch this.
Oh, boy. There he is. We got another one. He's not going to escape our voice.
3:38, the time of the elbowing penalty. Is he not the kind of player you love to hate, but you'd love to have?
Underneath the towel there on the right is the camera.
Both teams are shorthanded, but Peluso returns in 6 seconds. And the Blues with a 3-0 lead will have the man advantage here in the third period. The Wings with a puck. Peluso is on. And the Blues at full strength. Fedorov. Long shot and a good one. What a save by Fuhr. And the puck to center ice. Rouse, Lidstrom, Sandstrom, and Fedorov for Detroit. Puck shot in. Pronger plays it. Pronger, McInnes, Murphy, Hall, and Demitra on the power play. Here's Brett Hall. Pass to Joe Murphy. He gets slashed. And the puck behind the net out of the reach of Hall. McInnes is going to move in from the point. He'll leave the puck for Brett. Brett tees it up. The save by Vernon. Tomas Sandstrom takes the rebound and drives the puck the length of the ice. 1:10 to go in the penalty to Konstantinov. The Blues are 1-for-2 on the power play. They've been outshot in this period, 3-2. Pusher deflects the puck out of Campbell's reach. Now on the board, Petrovicki to Campbell. On with Courtnall. Petrovicki again to Jim Campbell in the corner to Courtnall, who's got a pair. Now to the blue line. Here's Courtnall to drive, and that's just wide. Ricard Pearson leaves the puck. Murphy takes it. And the shorthanded Wings on the rush. This is Chris Draper. Now over to Kirk Maltby. He shoots, score the save, rebound, Petrovicki to Campbell, 3-on-2. Campbell to Petrovicki and a backhander off Maltby. Campbell on a wraparound attempt, can't get a shot. Now to Ricard Pearson and the puck skips away. Still 17 seconds to go on the man advantage. The Blues have a commanding 3-0 lead here in game number 4. Pearson loses the puck and Rouse controls for Detroit. 5 seconds, Konstantinov returns. The Wings shoot the puck in. Chris Pronger with it. Now Konstantinov back on the ice. Up the boards to Mateau. He's stopped. kicks the puck back to Bergevin, over to Pronger. York, Mateau, and Murphy up front. This is Harry York, the Blues rookie, on Konstantinov, and a glove save by Vernon, and he leaves the puck, and the Wings start out. Darren McCarty playing it on the wing to Iserman, and he can't get around Pronger, who just clears the zone. He gets sandwiched down by Iserman and McCarty, who gets the puck again for Detroit. Bergevin intercepts the pass. Over to Mateau on the right wing, but the change has started. In fact, both teams changing. Better off from Fetisov around Bergevin, but Pellerin is back. The Blues really concentrating on good close checking, solid defense, and the puck knocked down by a high stick. That's the whistle. 13:33 remaining in the third. Blues up 3-0. The Blues lead the Detroit Red Wings. Ken Wilson, Joe Micheletti, and Rob Ramage. Pronger moments ago got sandwiched, Joe, by McCarty and Iserman.
Well, he's always a target because of all the ice time. Iserman, he didn't see behind him. Here comes McCarty, and he was able to defend himself pretty well. Keep an eye on McCarty all the way. Boy, he is logged again. All kinds of ice time tonight, and again played an excellent game.
Why am I starting to really focus on that clock, which shows 13:20 remaining?
Yeah, you don't worry about that. I'll watch the clock.
Here come the Russians. Oh, Fuhr robs Fedorov, set up by Larionov. Tip your hat to Grant Fuhr. Back to Konstantinov. Ahead for Larionov. In the slot for Konstantinov, knocked away. Blues can't clear. Larionov a pass. No one happened to be in the right circle. Pronger can't get the puck out. Konstantinov. Bumped by Conroy. Then Kozlov to the blue line to Fetisov. The pass tipped to Fuhr. He keeps the puck out. Pronger gets it and clears the zone. Wow, the Russians in periods 2 and 3 have been very impressive.
Yeah, and Grant Fuhr has been more impressive against them.
Now Hull trying to steal. Knocked down by Fetisov as the puck is cleared out. Here's McInnes firing it in. And the Wings go back. Bob Rouse. 3-0. The Blues lead it. A win, and they've evened the series at 2-2 with game 5 Friday night in Detroit. Now the puck taken. The Wings moving in. The pass and Kocher's effort taken away by McInnes. Ahead for Demitra, who's been brilliant. Now to Courtnall, looking for the hat trick. Goal, he shoots! And shoots wide as he was checked. He gets up in front, bumps with Rouse. Joe Koser gets the puck to Kirk Maltby. Draper trails. Maltby trying to get over the line is stopped. Demitra trying to clear, can't. Rouse keeps it in. The Blues really have done a good job standing up at their own line. Bergevin mixing it up with Maltby across the ice away from the play. Draper sweeps the puck behind the net, and Mark Bergevin takes over. He clears it up the boards and down the ice. Down to 11 and a half minutes remaining. Blues lead here in the third period, and Draper offside at the St. Louis blue line. 3-0, the Blues lead in game 4.
Well, while we are away, some extracurricular activity. Mike Peluso got into a shoving match with Kirk Maltby, and then Peluso ended up dropping his gloves when Brendan Shanahan intervened. And now we're waiting for the calls. Here's Maltby in the penalty box for Detroit. Peluso is already in the penalty box for the Blues. Here it is again. Now that's McCarty and Peluso, and here comes Shanahan with the push. And down go the gloves by Peluso. And Shanahan does a smart thing, not dropping his or his stick. And now we'll see what the penalty calls are. And just prior to all this, what a save again by Grant Fuhr. The Russians out there, there's the fake, the shot, and Fedorov from the other side, and Grant Fuhr just has and just knows where this play is going to end up. Look at that, what a save. Saved it with his bottom leg on Sergei Fedorov, who's still looking for his first point. And there's Fuhr again, look at that. Using his shoulder, then his elbow as the puck was heading towards the net. Used his shoulder and elbow to keep it out of the net.
Grant Fuhr already has a shutout in this series, bidding for his second of the series and fifth playoff shutout in his career. Coming up after the game, Fox Sports News. The Avalanche on the ropes, trailing by three in the third in Chicago. Cards Dodgers update, and of course a wrap-up of this Blues Wings game here at Kiel Center. Both teams get penalties. Peluso on sportsmanlike conduct, Malty cross-checking at 8:32. Courtnall and Demitra scored in the first period. No scoring in the second. Courtnall has scored here in the third. This is Demitra. Is he something? The pass for Hull tipped away. Larry Murphy trying to clear. Can't. Oh, a shot, and it goes wide. Iserman for the Red Wings. On with Shanahan, Murphy, and Lidstrom. Four offensive players that are outstanding. McInnes ties up Iserman. Pronger up the boards. Lidstrom whacks the puck ahead. Pronger takes it. Now McInnes up the boards for Hull. Lidstrom pinches in. The pass of beauty to Demitra with Pronger. Two on one. Here's Pronger moving in. He shoots. He scores! Chris Pronger! And the Blues have a 4-0 lead. And how about number 38, Pavol Demitra, having the game of a lifetime?
And it all started in the Blues end behind the net. McInnes around the boards to Hull, and Hull was able to move the puck out of the zone. As soon as Pronger saw that, he took off. There it is behind the net. Look at Pronger. He's in front of his own net. Now he sees it, and away he goes. He joins the rush, then Demitra with this perfect little pass just lays it out in front of him through the legs of Mike Vernon. The quick shot. Look at wait, quick shot through the legs. That makes it 4-0. What a pass from Demitra. Great work on the boards by Hull. And Pronger, reading all of it, joined the rush, something he has done so well in the last month. And he finishes the playoff.
Brett Hull has his third assist of the game, his seventh point of the playoffs, the first goal for Pronger. And yes, he's developing a large fan club here in St. Louis. Pronger from Demitra and Hull at 9:23. Demitra has a goal and two assists. And remember, on the first goal where he did not get a point, Demitra was instrumental in starting that play.
Exactly right.
As well as Hull has done, sitting next to Demitra on the bench, Pavol Demitra has just been terrific tonight.
That whole line, you talk about having to step up because of the absence of Pierre Turgeon and doing a job. I mean, it was, this line has been spectacular. Demitra has drawn up. Now watch, if we stop it here, there you see Pronger in front of his net. He's going to read it and just come back the other way. Here he comes, reads it, away he goes. And now Demitra and Pronger. Here he is. Pronger way back here, going to join the rush. And Demitra just takes his time. Now he feels the pressure and dumps the puck out in the open area so Pronger can just skate into it. And now Pronger with a lot of time. Boy, what a shot. Terrific shot through the legs of Vernon. And you think of Demitra, Courtnall, Hull, Pronger again. Al McInnes has been just a tower of strength in this game. And the Blues are up now 4-0.
And the Red Wings change goaltenders. Mike Vernon has been pulled, and Chris Osgood takes over here, 11-9 with a brilliant 2.18 goals against average in his Stanley Cup playoff career.
Well, Osgood played very well down the stretch for Detroit. He went through a period of time where he struggled. He'd let in a bad goal a game, but in his final four or five games, Osgood played very well for Detroit.
Well, a Blues victory would even the series at two aside. It would guarantee a game six here on Sunday afternoon at 1 o'clock, and there are good seats available yet for that one. Batisoff for Detroit. Gets the puck ahead. Konstantinov can't work too far in. Keeps the puck in. Better off to Larionov. Batisoff in front. McInnes gets in the way, and Fuhr's leg robs Larionov. The Russians out there. It's 4-on-4. Peluso and Malty in the penalty box. Fedorov to Batisoff, to Larionov, to Batisoff. His shot deflects over Fuhr into the crowd, and the clock shows 9:57 to go in the third period.
And still 29 seconds remaining on the minor penalties to Malty and to, who's the other guy? Mike Peluso. Thank you.
Meanwhile, Florida and the New York Rangers 3-3 in overtime. Remember, the first two games in Florida were 3-0 shutouts, so that series 1-1. They each got a shutout, and the Rangers and Florida really having a battle there tonight in Madison Square Garden.
Yeah, and as Rob Ramage was saying, 19 seconds remaining in regulation time. Luke Robitaille scores. Gretzky and Messier assist to send that into overtime.
They will play game four at Madison Square Garden tomorrow night. Still 4-on-4. McAlpine, a pass ahead. Demitra can't get around Rouse, and Draper speeds up the ice. Moving in with LaPointe, and the puck goes into the corner. LaPointe taken down by McAlpine. This is Hall up the ice. The Blues lead 4-0. Hall over to Pronger to Demitra. The deflection just wide. Here's Bob Rouse, and the penalties are over. Maltby and Peluso are back on. 9:24 to go. The pass from LaPointe too far. In the corner, Draper. McAlpine hits him. The Blues can't clear. Larry Murphy a pass, and that goes well wide. Bounce high in the air. To get the puck, McAlpine, and he'll clear it down the ice. The teams are changing. Larry Murphy for the Red Wings. The feed for Yzerman too far. This is Bergevin to McGinnis. 9 minutes to go. 4-0 Blues. The Wings again with a puck. Larry Murphy's pass behind Shanahan, and Campbell clears the puck out. The Wings with 6 shots, the Blues with 4 in this period, but the Blues have goals from Courtnall and Pronger. So it looks like both teams are going to be 1-1 on the road. In front, the Wings can't get a shot on goal. Now a penalty coming up here. Along the near boards, there'll be a penalty. It'll be against the Blues. Jim Campbell will go off with 8:25 remaining, and the Blues up 4-0.
The Blues will be shorthanded. Jim Campbell coming into the boards. That's Darren McCarty. Watch the elbow. Elbow right there. McCarty hits his face on the glass, and Campbell goes off. The Blues will be shorthanded.
11:35, the time of the 2-minute boarding penalty. Detroit will go to work on the power play. They are 0-for-2 tonight. Here's a shot. Fuhr, the save on that drive from Nicklas Lidstrom, and what a night this has been for Grant Fuhr.
And Detroit wins the faceoff cleanly. And Lidstrom has a terrific shot from the point. He just walks right into this one. Here it comes. Good job by Detroit getting the puck back to him, and then the final shot. And Grant Fuhr with a great leg save.
8:20 to go. The Blues are shorthanded. And the puck goes out of play. John and Mike Reichling, great Blues fans, coming by to say hi to their family and friends. Dave, Shauna, and Alex say hi to Ron, who's at home, and the gang rooting for the Blues at Don and Gene's house. Big hello to Margaret Sheets from Grant. He's here with the Obergefell wedding party. George Obergefell marrying Amy Harris of Collinsville. Now the Wings trying to keep the puck in, and it's gloved out by Pellerin. Pellerin and Conroy, Pronger, and Bergevin killing the penalty. The Blues lead it 4-0. Nicklas Lidstrom a pass. Pellerin gets in the way and clears the puck down the ice.
Now I'll tell you what, Kenny, the intensity level and the tempers of both these teams, players on both teams, are continuing to rise.
This is Larionov with a drop pass to Shanahan. Lidstrom over to Larionov. Behind the net for Yzerman. In the corner, McCarty. He's spun down by McInnes. Mateau carries the center ice. 7.5 minutes remaining. Leach back for Mateau. The Blues are shorthanded. Mateau killing valuable time. Finally run to the boards by McCarty. Brendan Shanahan cannot get around Leach, and the Wings are changing. 50 seconds to go, and the penalty to Jim Campbell, and the Blues clear the puck the length of the ice.
What a job of penalty killing thus far by the Blues. And you can just hear the constant buzz going on in this building, one of appreciation for what this team has done in this game.
Now the Red Wings offside at the St. Louis blue line. So the Blues win game one in Detroit, then the Red Wings come back. The Wings come here Sunday and take game three. And now it looks like the Blues are going to come back and win game four to even the series. Game five will be Friday night at Joe Louis Arena, 6:30 Central Daylight Time, right back on Fox Sports Midwest, Channel 2 on Sunday, and if needed, back in Detroit on KPLR-TV Channel 11 for game number seven. Under 7 minutes remaining in this one. 4-0 Blues. The Wings now out shooting the Blues tonight, 26-24. They get it in deep. Kozlov tips the puck to LaPointe, but knocked away by Bergevin, and Conroy finds an opening. 12 seconds to go in the Red Wing power play.
Kenny, when you think back to the start of this game, what the Blues wanted to do, stay out of the penalty box, play even strength, and they feel comfortable playing even strength, and they proved it.
McInnes with a puck, playing it around the boards, and it goes into the crowd off the glass. The Blues are trying to hand the Red Wings their first loss at Kiel this season. In the regular season, the Wings won here and tied, and of course won the first game of the playoffs.
And how about Al McInnes? Again, what an effort by him. We've talked about Fuhr and Demitra, Hall, Courtnall, Pronger. What about McInnes? You go back to game number three. McInnes played 37 minutes and 14 seconds in game number three. And again tonight, look at him. Look at the exhaustion on his face, trying to catch his breath. Out there all night, it seems like, again, and has been as good in the third period as he was in the first period.
Now the Blues control the puck. They control the game. McAlpine. Then York to Murphy. They get it out. Twist is out there with Murphy and York. Twist has a couple of stripes on his sleeve. He's just a sergeant in the police force. Now a big hit, and Mark Fawcett is going to call another penalty. All of a sudden here in the third period, and Joe was talking about it, tempers flaring, and with a game 4-0, you do things you wouldn't do if it was 1-0, and Joe Murphy goes to the penalty box.
Well, this could be a very long last 7 minutes of this game. This is Murphy, that's Pusher, and Murphy gets the left elbow up, it looked like. So the Blues will be shorthanded again, but this could be a long, long finish to this game.
They've all been good boys until the last few minutes. Let's go to Rob Ramage.
Well, guys, we'd like to see them kill this off for Grant Fuhr, but as Joe was saying, things could really degenerate here. I think it's important to Mark Fawcett really try and establish some control. So I think we're going to see lots of Mike Peliso and Tony Twist out there. Let's go back upstairs.
I think that's what Mark Fawcett is trying to do. I think he's got a good feel for what's happening in this game. And as this third period has gone on, we've seen a lot more behind the play, players using their sticks, a lot of talking going on between the players, and Fawcett has done a good job in this game, and now he's going to have a long last 6 minutes.
13:58, the time of the penalty to Joe Murphy. The Wings keep the puck in, then Bergevin gets it, and it goes the length of the ice. Detroit on the power play, 0-for-3, which means the Red Wings in the first four games of this playoff series are 2-for-25. On the power play. Those two goals, of course, were instrumental in their win here Sunday in game three. Lidstrom, a pass for Shanahan, broken up. The Blues are much more as they were in game one, no question about it. Standing up at the blue line, just playing well. Now there'll be another penalty called by Mark Fawcett. This one will be on Steve Yzerman.
And that's on Mark Bergevin. Yzerman just turned and gave him a two-hander across the left arm about 20 feet in front of Grant Fuhr. Now, here it is here. If we stop it there, watch the little hook. And right here, watch the slash by Yzerman coming up. Right there, just slashes him across the left arm. And Mark Fawcett down the lower left part of your screen sees it and makes the call immediately. Steve Yzerman has really looked frustrated. The Blues have done a good job against him, staying close to him, taking him out of the play, hooking him, slowing him down.
You said exactly what I was going to say. That's frustration.
Yeah.
That's all that is. It's frustration. And when you're down 4-0 with 5:24 to go, it's easy for that frustration to spill over. The Blues with a pair of goals tonight from Geoff Courtnall. They also have goals from Pavol Demitra and Chris Pronger. So it is 4-on-4, both teams shorthanded. Joe Murphy in the penalty box for the Blues. Konstantinov with Fetisov, Larionov, and Fedorov. The Blues with Demitra, Hall, Pearson, and McInnes. Here is Fedorov. Nice pass. Larionov trying to get a shot. Does! And it deflects over the net. Now we're down to 5 minutes remaining. The Blues lead 4-0. McInnes intercepts. The Blues have a 3-on-2 if they want it. They want it. Hall around Fetisov. Demitra and McInnes are in front. The pass to McInnes. He shoots. And that goes off Vernon's glove wide. In 40 seconds, Joe Murphy will come out of the penalty box. And the Blues will have a relatively short power play. Both teams changing. Larionov leads the rush for Detroit over to Chris Draper. He's had a good series and Fuhr stops him there. With the puck, Petrovicki up to Courtnall. Most importantly, he gets around that check from Fetisov. Larry Murphy dumps the puck in.
And Fetisov took a swing at Petrovicki.
Sandstrom loses the puck. The Blues take over. Here's McAlpine. He gets it out. Boy, the sticks are really flying. Now Lidstrom over to Murphy. Now Murphy, Joe Murphy back on. The Blues have a power play as McAlpine takes Tomas Sandstrom to the boards with 3:53 to go. They wrestle each other down. Here come the Blues, 3-on-2. Courtnall with Petrovicki and Joe Murphy. Courtnall to Petrovicki, he shoots, Osgood makes the save. And at the other end, McAlpine and Sandstrom just get separated. But what a chance there, and a great save by Chris Osgood.
Yeah, McAlpine was on top of Sandstrom after taking him down, and then it was Sandstrom that just kept on punching away. Here's McAlpine taking Sandstrom out. Now as they go down, Sandstrom ends up on the bottom, and McAlpine tries to get away. Now watch the hands and the stick of Sandstrom. And finally, McAlpine gets away. Before he does, he gets tackled, and the Blues ended up with a scoring chance in the other end.
Now look at our Ameritech scoring recap. In the first period, Courtnall at 5:50, Demitri at 18:51. No scoring in the second period. Here in the third, Courtnall second at 1:10 and Pronger at 9:23. Our Ameritech scoring recap. 3:43 to go. The Blues have a power play for 18 seconds. They're 1-for-3 tonight with a man advantage, and the puck deflects to center ice. McInnes and Pronger, York twist on the power play, and Campbell, clearly a reflection of a 4-goal lead. This, of course, means it'll not only be a Game 5 Friday, but a Game 6 here on Sunday afternoon. The penalty to Yzerman is over. This is McInnes over to Chris Pronger, rink wide to Harry York. He'll just flip the puck in, and the wing's Rouse goes back. The puck hops away from Pusher. York trying to get it, gets it in front. Campbell is shot. Good save by Osgood. Boy, the Blues doing all this without Igor Kravchuk and Pierre Turgeon. If you missed it, Turgeon had to be scratched, recurring headaches, and the doctors would not let him play. York ridden out by Aaron Ward, and here's Draper with 2:45 remaining.
Yeah, Kenny, and also a good job. We mentioned Petrovicki coming in, playing his first playoff game, and Harry York back into the lineup has played well also. It's been just a wonderful team effort.
2.5 to go, and if you're wearing white, look out for those in red as the teams are changing. 4-0, the Blues lead it. They have handily taken care of the Red Wings here tonight. And this crowd absolutely loves it. And it is a big crowd here at Kiev.
Kenny, I go back to the first half of the second period. The Blues leading 2-0. Detroit came out with a great start to the second period, had all kinds of chances, and Grant Fuhr was there to make some real key saves to keep it scoreless.
Petrovicki. Now 2 minutes to go. Mateau, 4-0 Blues centering. The puck knocked away by Shanahan, played by Fetisov. And finally, it hops over Shanahan, and it's offside. The Blues offside. 4-0. The Blues lead with 1:50 to go. Well, action has halted. Pusher and Peluso Joel Quinville has been alternating. Peluso and Twist, and young Jamie Pusher gets the better of Mike Peluso, but it happens with a minute 21 remaining in the third period, and the Blues with a commanding 4-0 lead.
Yeah, Kenny Peluso ended up going down, but I'm not sure he didn't get in some of the better punches early. And now Peluso and LaPointe, Sandstrom, there's Leach and LaPointe.
It all occurred again when they had him separated, but Peluso slammed into Kozloff as he was headed to the penalty box. Kozloff had his gloves on and his stick in his hand, and that gets everybody going here. Sandstrom and Pronger out there at center ice. The rest of the folks basically in the pile.
Yeah, and Pronger should do the right, yeah, he's saying take your visor off, but you don't want Pronger to get hurt here.
121
to go. You don't want Pronger to get in a fight.
Peluso does not want to go to the penalty box. He's wrestled down by the linesman. Meanwhile, off along the glass, just to the left of your screen, quite a battle going on there.
Yeah, I believe that's LaPointe. And
whoa! Pronger wailing away on Sandstrom. Rouse and Conroy are down to the right.
Right.
Rouse and Conroy dancing in the corner. And Mark Fawcett has his pencil and paper out. He can give everybody something. There's Conroy and Rouse. The one linesman trying to get Pronger and Sandstrom apart. That's Jean Marin. And the other linesman, Gerard Gauthier, now will go to work on Rouse and Conroy.
Yeah, and Pearson was ready to jump in there. If it would have been there.
Oh, there goes Pearson.
Well, Rouse took a swing at him. Oh,
now
Grant Fuhr.
Osgood. Here comes Fuhr. Here's Grant Fuhr in the middle of it. Don't get Grant Fuhr hurt in the pileup, whatever you do. Get Grant Fuhr out of there. He jumps in as soon as Osgood got involved. You know, I'm all for helping your teammate all the time, but if I were Grant Fuhr, I'd get out of there.
I agree. Now you got to watch the skates on the pile. Grant Fuhr just sits on top of Rouse, but he's got skates all around him. And he's got his gloves off. Get out of there, Grant.
Yeah, Grant, take a skate. Well, this is what happens in Stanley Cup playoff action when you have this continued intensity. Game in, game out. Osgood is really hot. Mark Fawcett telling Bob Rouse, you're not going to go. And he pulls Pearson and says, let's go.
Yeah.
And they're going to go. So this is nonstop. Here with a minute 21 remaining in the third period. It all started with Mike Peluso and Jamie Pusher, and they had it stopped, but Peluso ran into Kozloff as he was going to the penalty box, and everybody has gotten involved, including the goaltenders.
They're already, the maintenance people are on the ice down on the other end, starting to clean up that half as we still have fights going on down on the other side. Well, they got Pronger and Alfuhr and Osgood. And Pierre is saying, I'm glad you didn't want to fight. I wasn't up to it. But they stuck together. Now, high marks to Pearson for jumping in with a tougher Bob Rouse, Conroy. I mean, this team is together. So is Detroit. That's why this has been a heck of a series and will continue to be.
This will now come down to a best of three series with games 1 and 3 in Detroit and the middle game here in St. Louis. That's what it'll amount to now. Now the Red Wing players and the fans getting into it. The security guards are there. They better get the police and keep everybody calm.
Sorting out of all the sticks and gloves and the net out of there.
They're just getting warmed up here,
well,
game number four.
Yeah. Wait, this best of three series is going to be something, folks. It is going to be something. And you talk about two teams that are highly competitive and not willing to give anything. And you could just feel this coming, though. We talked about 7 minutes to go, about how long it was going to take, but you could feel it coming. There was a lot of things going on behind the play, pushing, shoving, the elbows started getting up, more of the stick work. I thought Mark Fawcett did as good a job as possible to keep this thing under control.
The Blues on Fox Sports Midwest, brought to you by Smooth Bush Beer and easy drinking Bush Light. Head for the mountains of Bush. And by Southwest Airlines, with fares so low, you have the freedom to go places.
Now, here's how it all got started. Peluso looked like Pusher challenged him. Didn't take long for them. Now, I think Peluso got a couple of good lefts in here first. Ah, he got a couple in. Pusher did a pretty good job, though. Not a lot of clean punches, and then Pusher is able to get a punch in once Peluso goes down. And now Pronger, he was trying to get the visor off. There he is. Look at him reaching to get the helmet off. And the visor, now he gets it. And look, everything was going to be calm. And then Pronger decided, nah, I'm not going to keep it this way. There it is. Boy, did he ever nail him with a right. He nailed him with about three. But that first one looked like it connected. Big time. And Mark Fawcett is on his second pencil.
I don't know why there would be that much trouble handing out penalties, because give as much as you want and everybody will deserve what they get, and if you miss anybody, don't worry about it.
You don't think anybody will be undeserving, huh?
No.
Well, Al McInnes gets a rest anyway to finish off this last 121.
The Blues lead it 4-0. We want to wish a big happy 8th anniversary to Matt Reardon and his lovely wife Tina. Matt from Fox Sports Midwest, happy 8th anniversary. The crowd reacts as they get that shot of Tony Twist with Grant Fuhr up on the Sony Jumbotron above center ice.
Now, and let's not forget the kind of performance that Grant Fuhr put in this game. Spectacular, in particular in the second period, the first 10 minutes. Mike Vernon was great the second half of the second period. The score could have been much worse. It was a great goaltending duel between those two. And this was a game where neither team just did not want to back down.
And it's time for our Discover Card Payback Playback. It's the fourth goal from Chris Pronger.
What a play by Demitra. Watch Demitra. Sees the hit coming. Throws the puck into the open area. Knows that Pronger is coming up. And a quick wrist shot through the legs of Mike Vernon. And that made it 4-0. It was a tremendous goal. What performances the Blues got from Demitra. Petrovicki stepping in to do a good job. Of course, Conroy was very strong. Pellerin again. Leach on Shanahan in this game. When you talk about a team performance, everyone contributed.
The Blues lead it 4-0. A minute 21 to go in the third period. We go back downstairs to Rob Ramit.
Hey, a little old-time hockey there. Minute 21 left in the game. How much of that do you think Tony Twist is going to play? Now, Chris Pronger, yeah, he got Sandstrom's helmet off, but I don't think he was going to give it to him until he looked over and saw Bob Rouse giving it to Conroy. And he said, hey, it's open season then. Good job by both teams. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, thanks very much, Rob. Still sorting things out down at the penalty bench. 4-0, the Blues lead it. Of course, a lot of other action tonight around the NHL in the opening round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Let's take a look at the other scores. New Jersey wins at Montreal. So that's 3-0 now, New Jersey. Rangers have won over Florida in overtime. And in the West, Chicago has a 6-3 lead in the third. Dallas at Edmonton 2-2. And there's no score. Anaheim at Phoenix.
The Rangers tied the game with 19 seconds to go in regulation time. And they win it in overtime on an unassisted goal by Esa Tikkanen.
They will play game 4 in that Florida Ranger series tomorrow night at Madison Square Garden.
All right.
This telecast, copyrighted, it's an exclusive presentation of Fox Sports Midwest in association with Bud Sports. The producer director of Blues hockey all season long, and he's done a great job, is Tom McLaughlin. His able associate producer is Tim Pabst.
I'll tell you what, our crew here in St. Louis, the pictures they bring, the replays, all our cameramen, everyone involved, again this year, they just continue to do a terrific job. Tommy and Timmy, everybody downstairs, it's I'll tell you what, it makes it a lot of fun to broadcast games when they show us the pictures and replays that they come up with, and my hat's off to all of them.
Don't forget, good seats are available for game number 6.
Hello, David.
It'll be this Sunday at 1 o'clock here at Kiel Center, game number 6. The penalties are being announced, and they're not going to miss too many people.
Oh, are we going to have some fun Friday night?
We're all looking forward to it.
Wow.
That game Friday night at 6:30 Central Daylight Time, right here again on Fox Sports Midwest. So be ready to go. Get yourself a nice easy chair or a bar stool and be with us from Joe Louis Arena on Friday night.
And not many people have left this game. I'll tell you what, the Blues have had a 4-0 lead for quite a while, and these fans have been standing and cheering and saluting this team for most of the game. They have been entertained, and this has been a hard-fought game between two teams that have played very, very hard. We've seen wonderful goaltending. Sergei Fedorov, as we just saw there, has yet to score a point in almost 4 games now.
Fuhr and Osgood both get penalties. Of course, Grant Fuhr is a minute 21 away from his second shutout in this playoff series, the 5th shutout of his Hall of Fame career. He had not had a shutout since he was in the playoffs with the Buffalo Sabres.
Boy, has he got that look to him. You talk about bearing down the stretch of games. And he has just been, he's been nearly unbeatable. Nearly unbeatable in this series. And how many times have we talked, you can't win unless you have great goaltending. You have to have it in the playoffs. And Grant Fuhr has certainly been providing that. This will be a great finish to this series.
The Blues may get an extra 2 minutes here.
Well, why don't you go over the penalties for us?
We have our able assistant, John. And about a minute and a half ago, he threw his hands in the air and said, I got no chance of getting them all written down for you.
You don't think these people here have been ecstatic over the play of Grant Fuhr and Joe Quenneville getting his team ready? He liked the way they played Sunday, and he said, as Rob Ramage talked about it at the start of the game, make sure you go out and initiate, but don't retaliate, and they haven't.
I can tell you that everybody except the goaltenders, Joe, got game misconducts. And Rouse got a little extra, but it's safe to say if you're really interested, read about it in the paper, and you can hope the Post-Dispatch gets it right. But quite a fight here at the 18:39 mark of the third period, and the officials would be best off to drop the puck and finish this minute 21. They're trying to explain everything to Scotty Bowman. They've already visited with Joel Quenneville.
Scotty obviously does not like the calls. And he's in a heated discussion, obviously, with the linesman here. Joel Quenneville, I think, just wants to get the game over with. Get on with it.
Also, by the way, speaking of Grant Fuhr, this will be the 80th career playoff victory for Grant Fuhr. That will tie him with the legendary Ken Dryden, third on the all-time playoff win list. Time now for our Bush players of the game tonight, Grant Fuhr and Pavol Demitra. Well-deserved honor.
Yeah, and if you're looking for other names, there are plenty, including Geoff Courtnall. Great return after what he's gone through the last day and a half with the criticism with his 5-minute major. Scored 2 goals in this game. Brett Hull, another great performance. There have been many.
And we're underway, just over a minute to go in the third period. The Blues lead it 4-0. Meanwhile, Chicago has a 6-3 lead up at United Center in the third, trying to even their series with Colorado at 2. Wouldn't that be something if both the Blues and Chicago pulled upsets in the first round? Eisenman for Detroit. Takes a shot that's blocked, and the puck thrown into the crowd by McInnes, and there'll be a penalty, I believe, called by Mark Fawcett undoubtedly for delay of the game. We'll get a look, I believe, as the glove of McInnes went flying.
Well, I'll tell you what happened is that McInnes and Shanahan came together in front. Now watch Shanahan hold on to the stick. McInnes can't get away, finally yanks it free, and then just dives down to block it. Goes right into his glove. He tries to just get rid of it. The glove goes off, the puck goes over, and Shanahan ends up with the penalty with 54 seconds remaining.
The Blues already were one man short. Yeah. They had gotten an extra penalty in the fight. Now they are two men short with 54 seconds remaining. So Grant Fuhr's shutout, you would have to think, is in danger here.
Yeah, and the other thing is Detroit pulls their goaltender, so it's a 6-on-3. Brett Hull has to win a faceoff here.
Hull, McAlpine, and Bergevin. Here's Detroit trying to get a goal. They trail 4-0. 48 seconds left. Murphy is shot wide. McCarty, Larionov, Yzerman, Shanahan, Murphy, and Lidstrom on for Detroit. They have pulled Osgood. They fake the shot. Murphy lets it go. Fuhr the save and the rebound wide. Half a minute to go. Boy, Detroit working awfully hard here just to get a goal and not get shut out for the second time. And the puck covered, play stopped. 28 seconds remaining in the game.
Yeah, and then they end up with Brett Hull without a stick. Shanahan came in behind him and pitchforked his stick. Watch Shanahan, 14 in the red. There's Brett Hull. Now watch what Shanahan does. Here it comes. Get rid of the stick. Get it out of the way. Now the Blues are really shorthanded. Hull without a stick. Grant Fuhr has to make another save. And now 28.1 seconds remaining.
Brett Hull piling up the points again in this game. He has had 3 assists. Hull has just been brilliant piling up the points in the first 4 games. 7 points in this series so far for number 16. The Blues are 2 men short. The Wings have pulled their goalie. It's 4-0 Blues. 23 seconds left. Over to Yzerman and a shot block. McAlpine, Demitra, and Bergevin trying to do the impossible. Yzerman, 11 seconds. Shanahan, Larionov, and the Blues get the puck, can't clear it. Then Demitra gets it out. It's going to be over. 1 second left, and the Blues have won game number 4. Grant Fuhr with his second shutout in this series. Fuhr with his 5th career playoff shutout. And Joel Quenneville's team has won the big game. They have tied this series at 2 victories apiece. Game 5 will be Friday night in Detroit. And this win assures a game 6 back here in St. Louis Sunday afternoon.
And what a great finish. Chris McAlpine blocked a couple of shots, and the Blues were able to clear the puck and help Grant Fuhr preserve the shutout. What a job he did. You can go up and down the roster. Pierre Turgeon could not play, and the newcomers coming back into the lineup did a spectacular job. Igor Kravchuk out, and this was just a remarkable performance by a real team that stuck together and battled through this game for the win.
Final shots, the Wings 28 and the Blues 27. So that's really the story. The Blues get the great performance from Grant Fuhr, the 2 goals from Geoff Courtnall. Demitra and Pronger also get goals. Hull and Demitra piled up plenty of points. Demitra and Hull each had 3 points. So the Blues get the victory. Fox Sports News is next. For Joe Micheletti and Rob Ramage, I'm Ken Wilson. Thanks for being with us. 4-0, the Blues win it.
More playoff action tonight as the Red Wings try to let St. Louis sing the blues. Fox Sports News is now.
Game 4 from the Kiel Center, Brett Hull and the Blues looking to even the series at 2-2. First period, Wings turn it over. Hull to Chris McAlpine. McAlpine to Geoff Courtnall, who gets the goal. Blues up 1-0. Later in the first, Hull shoots. Pavol Demitra gets the rebound and knocks it in. Blues up 2-0 after 1. Second period, Igor Larionov shoots, but Grant Fuhr is there. Big night for him. Still 2-0 after 2. Third period, Demitra, nice pass to Courtnall for the goal. St. Louis goes up 3-0. Later in the third, Blues with the 2-on-1, Demitra to Chris Pronger. He beats Vernon. Blues up 4-0 and feeling mighty good. Final minutes, Red Wings showing their frustration. Even Fuhr gets involved. And finally, the fans get into it with the Wings. This thing got out of control. Blues going to win it. 4-1 is the final. Fuhr's second shutout, fifth career. Fuhr ties Ken Dryden for third all-time in playoff wins with 80.
Fox 10 takes us to St. Louis, where Ken Wilson and Joe McAletti are standing by with just another night at the Kiel. Fellas, it's all yours.
Grant Fuhr gets the shutout in the Blues' 4-0 victory, his second shutout of this playoff series, the fifth shutout in his brilliant career. Well, one of the keys undoubtedly for the Blues heading into the playoffs, Grant Fuhr, he was terrific. Geoff Courtnall gets those two goals, and Pavol Demitra is great. You can't say enough about the performance by the Blues.
No, and you can continue that. Brett Hull had another big offensive night. And maybe the, what's been the key to this series so far is the durability of the Blues defenseman. Chris Pronger, again, logged a lot of ice time. Al MacInnis the same way, Mark Bergevin. So as a team, they stuck together tonight. They really put up just a heck of a performance against a Detroit team that as well put up a good performance.
Demitra, key. He gets a goal on a rebound here from Hull.
Yeah, Brett Hull with a brilliant move, and Demitra just simply followed it up and put it into the empty net. That goal made it 2-0.
And, of course, Geoff Courtnall, a big goal early in the third that made it 3-0.
Again, the setup from Demitra, the perfect pass across, and Courtnall with his third of the playoffs.
It's on to Detroit for Game 5 Friday night back here in St. Louis on Sunday afternoon. That's the story back to the Fox Television Center.
Thank you, Ken and Joe. So Brett Hull, who led St. Louis in scoring during the regular season, has just one goal during the playoffs, but he has 6 assists. Welcome inside Stage 2 here at the Fox Television Center. Along with John Walls, I'm Dwayne Ballen. This is Fox Sports News.